Some equipment described as optional.
Come test drive yours today at Mercedes-Benz of North Haven, proud sponsors of Quinnipiac Athletics.
See us online at MercedesBenzOfNorthHaven.com.
Are you an early bird or a night owl? Well, TD Bank is both. You see, TD Bank is open longer than other banks. They're also open 7 days a week. Of course, you can always visit them online at TDBank.com or give them a ring at 888-751-9000. Because you can talk to an actual person 24/7, 365 days a year. It's part of what they call banking human. And it's why TD Bank is America's most convenient bank. Member FDIC, TD Bank NA.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max, I want a Pepsi Max, I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Dang! Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner! Catch!
Whoops!
Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa! Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
How did I get here? Dumb luck? Or good decisions? About marriage? Children? Money? About tomorrow?
Who matters most to you says the most about you. At MassMutual, we're owned by our policy owners, and they matter most to us. Learn more at massmutual.com/mutuality. Ready to plan for your family's future?
Abshire looks, bounces left side for Cannon. Now out to Warner, lobs it down low. McQuain up and lays it in.
Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball brought to you by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. By Pepsi, the choice of a new generation. By Dunkin' Donuts, America runs on Dunkin'. By Morrow Motors, Mercedes-Benz and BMW of North Haven. By Mass Mutual, they'd like to help you make good financial decisions to protect the people who matter most to you. And by the Beach House Restaurant in Milford. What's not to like? Great food, great staff, super music.
Back in the TD Bank Sports Center, Bob Mortali and Bill Mecca, starting lineups being introduced for today's game between Quinnipiac and North Carolina A&T. The Bobcats go with Brittany McQuain in the middle, 5'11 senior from Independence, Missouri. Ellen Cannon gets the start in the backcourt, 5'6 senior from Westchester, Pennsylvania. Also Jasmine Martin, 5'8 junior from Sookerville, New Jersey. Samantha Guastella on the front line, 6'1 junior from Red Bank, New Jersey. And Gillian Boo Abshire at the point, 5'10 junior from Washington, D.C. For North Carolina A&T, they go with Debbie Smith in the backcourt, a 5'10 junior from Hampton, Virginia. Also Adriana Nazario, a 5'8 junior from Charleston, West Virginia. Tracy King, a 5'10 senior from Alexandria, Virginia. April McCray, who scored 20 points in their exhibition game against Christopher Newman the other night. McCray is a 6'3 sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina. And Ariel Bursey, a 5'10 junior from Sanford, North Carolina. A&T, by the way, last year played in the MEAC tournament, the Mideast Athletic Conference tournament, losing in the semifinals to Howard, 22-10 a year ago, and a 13-3 mark in conference play. The Aggies were in dark blue uniforms with yellow numbers. Quinnipiac in the home gold with the dark blue trim. And a bit of a delay as we get things straightened together. Some shot clock issues already off the bat.
Well, you got a whole lot of new technology here at the TD Bank Sports Center. Got $1 million scoreboard, Bobby. Go ahead.
And we'll take 10 seconds for station identification on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Quinnipiac basketball exclusively on AM 1220 WQUN Hamden. Drive to work with Ray Andrewson, mornings from 6 to 10.
Bobcats will go from right to left here in the first half. We'll talk about all the new toys at halftime with Coach Mecca as we get set. Where ball is tipped into the backcourt. It's taken by A&T, and Aggies left first possession. Nazario in the backcourt, slowly walking across to the midcourt line. She's picked up by Jasmine Martin, moving to the near sideline, dribbling at the wing. Now tries to get around McQuain and does so. Top of the three-point arc, a right-side pass to Bursey. Bursey's watched by Cannon as they play man. Burse. He throws one inside from McCray, bumps with Guastella in the low post, fumbles the ball, now throws up a shot off the side of the backboard, no good. Rebound on the floor, four players go for it, and a tie ball possession goes to Quinnipiac.
Well, real good defense possession that time by Quinnipiac. Great weak side help by Samantha Guastella. It's a team that's going to play good defense because it's a team that believes in each other.
Full court pressure off the inbounds pass. Ball goes to Abshire, and Abshire will run things as she moves it across past us. In the forecourt is a bump as they just moved near us, and a foul right near the half court line is going to go against A&T, against Nazario, her first.
Well, I think we'll see a lot of fouls early in the year. Bobby, they changed a whole lot of rules. You put your hand on an offensive player, they're going to blow the whistle.
Quinnipiac ball inbounds to Abshire between the circles, moves to her right, gets a pick from McQueen out of the right corner for Guastella. One dribble, has to poked away by King, and King recovers. Aggie's ball, King quickly throws it to the forecourt for Bercy. Left side, looking back in on Martin, there's a bump there as well. Looks like Jasmine Martin picked up her first foul of the season.
But we're going to have to struggle a little bit now as broadcasters and as fans with the new rules in college basketball. They're looking to guard things real tight. You put your hand on an offensive player, they're going to call it. They're trying to speed up the game, trying to get it to be more offensive.
Bercy will inbound at the end line to our right. No score in the first 45 seconds of action. Inbounds to Smith, left corner, watched by Abshire. Soft pass off the hand of King, able to recover between the circles, and gets it out to Nazario. She dribbles to the Quinnipiac bench, guarded by Martin, gets a pick from King. Now he's picked up by McQueen. Throws a pass, it's deflected at the foul line, taken off by Cannon, who cradles the basketball, and then throws it off to Abshire. Abshire quickly to the left wing of the forecourt. To the corner, it's Martin. The three-pointer is good.
Now she made a home down there last year, off to a great start, good feed. In transition by Quinnipiac.
First shot of the game from downtown for Jasmine Martin. It's 3-0 Quinnipiac. Nazario on the right wing, near sideline. Back again on Martin. Looks for a pick. Goes around McQueen to the foul line. Left side pass for Bercy. Her three-pointer is off the back iron. No good. Abshire in the low post with the rebound. And she pushes the tempo. It's 4-on-3. Abshire quickly to the forecourt to the right wing. Stops her dribble. The bloop inside for Guastella. Right low post. Back off for Cannon. She pulls the trigger on a three-pointer. It's an air ball. Just grazed the bottom of the net. And it's taken up off the floor by Tracy King. King of the forecourt. Pass almost knocked away by Cannon. Goes to the low post. And then a traveling call as Bercy shuffled her feet.
The thing that impresses me early on, Bobby, is in a sense of taking a peek at Brittany McQueen. And you're talking about a young lady who was all everything last year. Has got herself really fit this year. Great transition defense that time by Brittany.
Quinnipiac ball, Abshire's pass, intended for Martin, has to scramble with Bercy, and Bercy makes the steal in what turns out to be the backcourt. Now throws it up to Nazario. Cross the logo, into the forecourt to the foul line. Kicks it out to the left for Debbie Smith for a long three-pointer. It's good.
A good answer by A&T that time in transition off a forced turnover by Abshire. Good three-pointer.
We're tied at three. 17:53 to go in the first half. Right corner three-pointer by Cannons off the back iron. That's no good. Taken up by Nazario. Nazario weaves her way into the forecourt to the right of the foul line. Pulls up for a two-pointer. That's short. And McQueen able to save the rebound for Cannon. Five subs about to come in for Quinnipiac at the next whistle. The gold rush is on again. Abshire, right wing forecourt. Stops the dribble. Needs some help. Finds Cannon in front of the Aggie bench. Holds it over her head. Now puts it on the floor once. Watched by King. Bounces one to Guastella right of the lane. Face of the basket. Cross-court feed from Martin. Left side three-pointer. Around the rim and in.
Good feed that time by Guastella. Opposite low post. Look opposite. Martin framed up. Bam. Knocks it down.
2 3-pointers for Jasmine Martin. It is 6-3 Bobcats. 17-13 remaining in the first half. Walking it across to the forecourt is Nazario. Left side pass over to Tracy King. Watched by Guastella. Right side for Bercy. Her three-pointer is off the front rim. No good. But Aggie's able to get the rebound. King, guarded closely by Abshire, gets it out for Nazario in front of the Bobcat bench. He dribbles to her right. Picked up by Boo. Needs movement from her teammates. Looking for help. Continues to dribble with the right hand. Gets around McQueen. To the right of the foul line. Bounces one right corner. Pump fake by King. Now she's on the drive. Goes up with a two strong off the backboard. Taken off by Cannon. Cannon cradles it, now gets it out to Abshire. Far sideline, forecourt. To the left corner, Guastella. She pulls a trigger. That's from downtown and hits.
But they're not afraid to shoot the ball from three. Good job by Guastella. Any chance you can bring a post player out, you get a quick timeout here by A&T. You push your post player out in transition. Opportunity to have a real good year.
So a quick timeout called as 3 3-pointers now for the Bobcats, and they have a 9-3 lead. We're going to take a break right here with 16:30 remaining in the first half. Bobcats up. 9-3, we'll be right back.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year. At the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut, the Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Stay in touch with all the latest Bobcats news at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Everything you ever want to know about all 21 Quinnipiac University athletic teams. The latest results, stats on the players, feature stories on the athletes, and action photos. It's all yours at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Bookmark it as one of your favorites, QuinnipiacBobcats.com.
Back at the TD Bank Sports Center, Bob Mortali and Bill Mecca. It's been all outside shooting from downtown the first 3.5 minutes, with the Bobcats had three of the 4 3-pointers for the early 9-3 lead.
Well, early on, I see a team that's filled with confidence. And as I said before, when you have confidence, you can have fun. And when you have fun, you can do some amazing things. Quinnipiac hasn't missed a beat. You got Martin and Guastella knocking down big threes.
Now we have a second five in. We'll set the Quinnipiac lineup for you as we go. Also in, Christina Carter for North Carolina A&T. She's at the right wing, guarded by Adelie Martucci, making her first Quinnipiac appearance. They pass it over to the right side for Debbie Smith. Pulls up for a three-pointer, right wing around the rim. No good. Fought for on the rebound. King able to control it on the baseline. Goes back to the right corner. Throws one inside, stolen by Martucci in the low post. She'll stop her dribble and flip to Nicolaine Ostergaard. Ostergaard to the forecourt to the right wing. Stops the dribble, finds freshman Morgan Manns. Now out to Martucci, left baseline on the drive. Cross-court feed for Maria Napolitano, but it's a collision. A North Carolina A&T player is down on a charge. It's going to be called against Quinnipiac.
Well, it's the first time we've seen Martucci now. Again, much heralded redshirt freshman last year, came real good handle that time on the baseline. Thought she made a good play. I thought she high jumped, made a real good feed. They got her for a charge.
So that's the second team foul, first on Martucci. Also in the Quinnipiac lineup, Cameron Warner's in there. You mentioned Morgan Manns, one of the new players this year, and Maria Napolitano. So they go with Martucci, Manns, Warner, Napolitano, and Ostergaard. So the Gold Rush procedure for substitution is in effect for this year already. If you get the live action, Carter in front of the Bobcat bench, throws one to the left low post on the spin move. DeAndre Davis has it knocked away. McCray able to go in off the backboard on the follow.
That first time McCray's been able to get free inside, coming off a big effort in an exhibition game the other night.
9-5, Bobcats by four. Ostergaard right of the lane, forces up a layup. She's called for steps.
Well, pretty good move by Ostergaard now. This is a group, the Gold Rush, that has always got Quinnipiac an advantage, you know. And over the course of a game, you're going to get a team that's going to wear down your opponents. Couple new players. You got Martucci and you got Morgan Mann, so you don't have the connection with this group that we saw with the first five.
Substitution for A&T, Tepetope Oladele, a junior from Nigeria, into the Aggies lineup. It's 9-5, Bobcats by four. Carter between the circles on Martucci, bounces one to the foul line from McCray. Puts it on the floor once, gives to Smith on the curl, lost control, then recovers. Carter now inside, pass knocked away, intended for McCray. Warner got a hand on it and knocked it out of bounds.
Good effort down there in the low post by Cameron Warner, who gives Quinnipiac a lot of energy down there in the low post.
Carter holds up five fingers to call out the play on the inbounds pass. She's on the end line, looking for some help, needs some movement, throws it out for Davis. Davis backing away from the three-point arc straight away, guarded by Napolitano, five on the shot clock. Pass to Smith. Smith on the move, pulls the trigger from 23 feet, and it's off the rim, no good. Play continues as the ball is loose on the floor. It's saved by McCray, gives it back to Smith, and a fresh shot clock. Gives to Carter now on the curl by the logo, watched by Martucci. Martucci guarding her closely, trying to poke the ball away. Spin move on the drive, and Carter on the acceleration, she's fouled.
Well, it's not going to take a whole lot for them to call a foul on a defender this year. One little spin move, and Martucci didn't even really initiate that contact. A lot of contact initiated by the offensive player, and just like the players, I think the officials are going to have to start figuring out how tight should they call the game.
So it's opening day for the officials too, as the starting five comes back for Quinnipiac. Martucci's second, foul team's third. A&T with the ball. It is Davis between the circles, watched by Jasmine Martin, moves to her left, finds Smith in front of the Bobcat bench. Dribbles with the right hand. She's guarded by Abshire. Now the left corner, the pass to Davis, goes baseline and hits.
Davis, pretty good player, was able to take the ball along the baseline that time and elevate a little bit and knock down a three-footer.
And it's 9-7. Bobcats by a deuce, 14:29 to go in the first half. Abshire guarded by Carter as she moves to the far sideline on the forecourt. To Cannon in front of the A&T bench. Out on top, Martin. Open for a three-pointer straight away. That's four three-pointers for the Bobcats.
They don't know nothing about Jasmine Martin there, do they, Bobby? You can't leave her open. You leave her open, his money in the bank.
Three threes for Jazz. She has 9 points. It's 12-7 Quinnipiac. And she will not hesitate to pull the trigger when she gets the opportunity. Carter in the forecourt for A&T. Bots one of the foul line for McCray. Watched by McQuain. Gives it to Smith on the curl to her left. Right side pass now for Carter. beyond the three-point arc near the sideline. Shot clock at 8. An offensive foul away from the play has been called an A&T.
They got the low post player that time, Bobby, with a push off McCray, and real good defense that time by Brittany McQueen. You can see her now as a senior getting a lot smarter. Basketball IQ is rising. She initiated contact, walked away, and the ref got the second one.
McCray's first personal, second on the team. Quinnipiac ball with Abshire racing past us in the forecourt to the left wing. 13:47 left first half. Bobcats lead it 12-7. Cannon, far sideline, beyond the three-point arc. Holds it up over her head. And now a whistle again away from the ball, and a foul looks like it'll be called against A&T. So we're going to have a long game tonight with a lot of whistles.
Well, we are, you know, and again, it's not basketball. You're going to have to get used to it. You're going to have to play through it. And you're going to get a lot of teams over the course of the early season playing a lot of zone.
Kings first, and the third team following the Aggies. Abshire with the basketball with 13:30 left to go in the first half. The give to Martin. She drives in the lane and banks it off the glass.
You always want to see if your players are able to bring something new to the table. You know, Martin's a good standstill shooter. We saw her put it on the floor, lay it to the basket with a left hand. If the girl can shoot it and take it to the hole, she's an All-American.
Biggest lead of the game at 7 points and away from the play. Another foul is called, this time on A&T. And I believe they've got Carter. Let's see. No, Tepetope Oladele, the junior from Nigeria, picks up her first personal foul. Team's fourth.
They got her on an illegal pick on a little UCLA shuffle cut.
Quinnipiac ball leading by 7, inbound to Abshire. Still some pressure in the backcourt. Abshire working one-on-one in the forecourt against Carter. Dribbles to the left wing. Needs some help, finds Cannon open right corner momentarily. Doesn't shoot, and then the pass attempt's kicked away out of bounds by Smith, so it's a kick violation.
Well, you know, teams aren't really familiar with each other, but clearly A&T has made a decision. They don't want Brittany McQueen to catch the basketball. Brittany hasn't caught it, but they forgot about Jasmine Martin.
No, they did. Quinnipiac shooting lights out from a three-point range, 4-6 so far in the first half. Inbounds to McQueen, far sideline. Out on top for Abshire, lost control of it, and it's taken up by Debbie Smith. Smith racing to the forecourt. Abshire picks her up on the foul line. Moves to the left corner, needs help, gets it back for Nazario. Nazario watched by Martin in front of the Quinnipiac bench. The pass down on top for King. King left of the foul line, gives it back for Nazario. Feed inside for Oladele. She's open in the low post, but misses the shot off the rim. Rebound off the floor to Guastella. Double team. Needs some help. Bounces over Abshire. Boo looks to accelerate. Far sideline. Front of the scorer's table. Now cross-court feed left corner. Martin again from downtown. Good!
Real good vision that time by Abshire. Cross-court pass. Thought it got there a little slower than I would like. Real good catch and finish by Martin, who is off to an incredible start.
She has 4 3-pointers, 14 of the 17 points in the first half, 17-7. Bobcats by 10. King of the forecourt for A&T, moves to her left. Throws one cross court for Carter, drives right baseline, goes up with a layup attempt. That's no good. Might have been partially deflected. McCray fouls. She can't hit. Ball loose at the sideline. They let it go out of bounds, and they say go ball, so it's Quinnipiac possession.
Yeah, I think that's amazing to me, Bobby, is the sense that the business approach to this game by this Quinnipiac women's basketball team. A lot of fanfare, but they're playing hard, they're focused, and real good job over there by Trish and her staff. Getting the team prepared.
They're experienced, they know what to do, and they're getting it done so far with a 10-point lead inside of 12 minutes to go in the first half. Abshire to McQueen, out on top. Puts it on the floor a couple times with the right hand, gets it to Martin, left wing. Loop inside for Guastella in the low post, and away from the play again. Another foul, as the official said, let's go down. It's going to be against the Bobcats.
Well, they got that time Guastella with her hand on a defender that time pushing off, and really a call we're just not used to seeing.
And we have a timeout on the floor, 11:50 to go in the first half. Bobcats 17, North Carolina A&T 7. Back with more on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Have you thought about your soul lately? Life is crazy busy. How about a break for you and your soul? This is Dan Darling, and CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com is your place for inspiration. You can read a text, watch a video, journal some thoughts, and share a thought. But you can be inspired today through CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com. Subscribe today.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special, $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com. TDBankSportsCenter.com.
Winning day for the Quinnipiac women at the TD Bank Sports Center. Bob Mortali with Bill Mecca. The Bobcats with a 10-point lead at 17-7. And not only is Quinnipiac shooting lights out for three-point range, their defense has been stellar, just 3 of 13 for the Aggies in shooting.
They've done a real good job, you know, with a team that you really don't know a lot about. And I think Trish has spent a lot of time worrying about her team, you know, and getting her team focused. And they're playing good fundamental defense. And one of the advantages they have is the second five is as good as the first five. Their practices are very competitive.
It is Aggies ball. They're moving from left to right here in the first half. Carter with the basketball, guarded by Shayna Earle, who's making her first appearance after a knee injury in the part of last season. The give to Nazario, watched by Ostergaard. Second five in for the Bobcats. Nazario moves to her left around Ostergaard, goes down the left side of the lane. A pass attempt is deflected off the backboard. A foul's going to be called on Quinnipiac.
Well, if I'm an opposing coach now, and if I'm coaching basketball, I'm recruiting kids that can take the ball to the basket, because at any point now you take the ball to the basket, any contact by the defender is going to get you to the foul line.
That foul was on Nicoline Ostergaard, her first, team's fifth. The foul before the timeout was on Samantha Guastella. That's her first, as Nazario missed the first free throw at the basket to our right. Nazario had 16 points in that exhibition game against Christopher Newport the other night. She makes the second, goes one out of two, and it's 17-8. Shayna Earle in the backcourt. Double team, wearing a knee brace on her right knee, by the way. And then she's called for traveling. Great pressure on the double team by the combination of King and Carter.
A real good substitution, giving Earl an opportunity to play. You know, she missed all of last year after that injury with her knee, Bobby. And again, she just needs some game reps to get back to where she was.
Aggies ball down 9, 17-8, 11-20 to go in the first half. Dribbling at the logo is Nazario. Ostergaard the defense, both arms straight up in the air. Pass to the left side for Carter, almost knocked away, able to control it. It's working on Earl. Front of the Bobcat bench, now she dribbles to her right. With the right hand, hits the top of her head to call out a signal. 9 of the shot clock. Carter to the foul line, goes into the lane, forces up a shot off the back iron, and the foul's called on Quinnipiac.
I think we've seen now with this second Gold Rush group that's come in, second time they've been in the game, having a difficult time guarding the girls off the bounce. A couple times we've seen these matchups haven't favored Quinnipiac. So curious to see now as Trish continues to go with the Gold Rush, does this second group maybe become a group tonight that's going to play a little bit of zone?
Carter makes the first free throw. The foul is on Cameron Warner. Her first, 16 fouls now for Quinnipiac. We're inside 11 minutes to go in the first half. 17-9. The Bobcats lead by 8, and Jasmine Martin has 14 of the 17 Bobcat points with 4 3-pointers. Second free throw by Carter is around the rim, no good. Ostergaard takes in the rebound for the Bobcats and finds Earl. Earl in the backcourt, dribbling in front of us, and is a bump at the half-court line, and a foul against A&T.
It's going to take a while for everybody to start figuring this thing out a little bit, you know. And again, whoever put this idea together that you're not going to let a defender touch the offensive player is nuts. You need to control the offensive team.
Morgan Manns practically in front of us, bounces one to the backcourt on the inbounds to Earl. 10:50 to go first half. Bobcats lead at 17-9. Earl to Warner, far sideline. Watched by King, out on top Ostergaard. Looking for movement, throws to Earl, left side, to the low post, Warner, faces the basket, spins, goes up with the left hand, no good off the rim, taken off by Carter, and it's A&T ball. Carter, dribbling past the logo with the left hand, left side pass for Nazario. On the drive to the baseline, pulls up, can't find a room, gets it to Carter, right wing. Carter switches hands on the dribble, guarded by Earl. Left side pass for Bursey. Ariel Bursey working on Morgan Mann, to the left corner for King, shot clock at 8. King needs some help. Almost knocked away by Earl, and it's into the backcourt with 5 on the shot clock. Carter racing to the forecourt. Top of the arc. Now the pass, they're going to say that the shot would have counted, and the play continues after the shot goes off the rim, but it's taken off the floor by Nazario. So they just beat the shot clock with that desperation three-pointer. Out on top for Bursey. As the starting five comes off the bench for Quinnipiac at the next whistle. Bursey feeds inside, knocked away from McCray, taken off by Shayna Earle. She throws down court for Ostergaard, who gets by a defender, goes down to the left low post, feeds inside for Warner, no good, gets her own rebound, hits the bottom of the backboard, third attempt against a triple team, no, she gets it to Napolitano, and a 3-second call against Quinnipiac.
A little unlucky that time by Cameron Warner inside. I thought she got fouled twice, Bobby. No call, and then as she's passing the ball out, she gets called for 3 seconds, and my understanding of the rule is every time you get a new touch, you get a new three.
We will continue to decipher the new rules as the season progresses, as the starting five now back in for Quinnipiac. Bobcats lead 17-9, 9:34 to go in the first half. Nazario with the basketball, dribbling into the forecourt with the left hand, moves to the left wing, hands it off on to Curla Bursey. Out on top, King. Watched by Guastella. Gets a pick from a teammate, moves to her left around McQueen. Out on top, Debbie Smith. Top of the three-point arc, shot clock at 10 as Abshire knocks it away. It's controlled by Nazario. Six on the shot clock. Nazario moves to her right, still beyond the three-point arc, pulls up for a three-pointer and hits it.
Yeah, real good defense that time by Quinnipiac. Only thing an A&T could do was pull as the shot clock was winding down, pull up and shoot a desperation three that fell in.
17-12, Bobcats by five. It's Martin in the forecourt. Has it knocked away, lost control, recovered by the Aggies. It is Nazario, racing to the forecourt. Bounces one to her right for Bursey on the drive. Protects the ball, shot no good on the layup attempt. And it's rebounded by Abshire. Tries to get around Bursey, she's hooked, and it's a foul against the Aggies. Ariel Bursey's first personal foul, team six. So six team fouls for each team.
Well, the good news for Quinnipiac is that Martin's hasn't missed a shot. She's got 14 points. The bad news is they only got three from everybody else. So somehow now we got to get Quinnipiac's offense in the game. You got to get Brittany McQueen some touches and then work inside out.
Abshire with the basketball for Quinnipiac. Bounces one to her right for McQueen. Beyond the three-point arc. Gives to Martin right of the foul line. Back to Brittany. Needs him held. Cross-court feed for Abshire. Left corner. Drives the baseline. Gets Nazario. Stops in the low post. Back for Ellen Cannon. Wide open three-pointer is good.
Good feed by Abshire. Able to turn the corner. Come to a jump stop and hook a pass out to Cannon. If you leave her open, you're going to pay.
Ellen's first points of the afternoon, 20-12. Bobcats by 8 with 8:11 to go in the first half. Nazario, top of the three-point arc, right side Davis to the right corner, King. Bounces one to the low post from McCray, inside, and there's a whistle and a traveling call at the right low post.
Yeah, great job defensively that time. Real good job by Brittany McQueen getting in front of McCray in the low post. Great weak side help by Abshire causes a travel.
Guastella facing some pressure on the inbounds pass, gets it to Abshire. The 2-1-1 defense. Abshire moves around. Nazario able to protect the basketball on the left wing. Stops a dribble left of the foul line. They give to McQueen, left low post. Cross court for Guastella. Her three-point attempt from the right side is good. This team is on fire.
Well, I like the feeds that time. And you've seen a couple times from the opposite low post, opposite look, opposite when you catch. Good catch and finish that time.
7 of 9 from downtown for the Bobcats. They lead it 23-12. 7.5 to go in the first half. Davis, right wing of the forecourt, got it by Abshire, near sideline to the foul line. The pass knocked away. Intended for McCray, taken off by Martin. It's a 2-on-2 break. Martin, right of the foul line, goes down the lane. There's a collision, and the foul's going to be called. It's like a blocking foul this time against the Aggies.
You see fatigue setting a little bit in for A&T. I know we've played 13 minutes, but you've had a couple groups of substituted for Quinnipiac. Already played 11 people. A&T starting to get a little careless and a little tired.
Debbie Smith with the foul. Is a timeout on the floor. 7 minutes, 21 seconds remaining in the first half. Quinnipiac leads at 23-12. We'll be right back.
Get your coffee from the folks that know coffee inside and out. For over 60 years, we've kept America running with our dedication to serving the freshest cup of coffee. Dunkin' Donuts. America runs on Dunkin'. You want your coffee quick, freshly brewed, and ground from only the finest beans. Make the most of your day with the fresh ground taste of America's favorite cup of joe. At Dunkin' Donuts, you can do it. Dunkin' Donuts coffee. America runs on Dunkin'.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. 4 mornings a week, I try to get a run in. And I know that I'm supposed to drink a glass of water after my run, but there's the Dunkin' Donut right on the way home.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. When you get that first cup of coffee in the morning, it starts your day off right. You know, pre-coffee, you should keep your distance. Once I have my Dunkin', I'm all good.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Back at the TD Bank Sports Center, Bob Mortali, Bill Mecca. The Bobcats lighting up from 22 feet and beyond with regularity. You mentioned 7 out of 9 for three-point range and 61% overall shooting as they hold on to the double-digit advantage of 23-12.
You know, I think it's an important thing, obviously, to be able to put the ball in the basket, but I think the thing that goes unnoticed is to be able to deliver the ball early enough so someone can go ahead and take the shot uncontested. And you've seen some real good passes from Abshire, McQueen, Cannon, to get themselves in a position where their teammates can knock down the open looks.
Jasmine Martin to the foul line to our left, shooting the free throw. It is in the air. It is good. She'll get one more. Jasmine, by the way, all of last year, never had more than 4 3-pointers in a single game. She had 4 in the first, 6 minutes tonight? That's pretty good.
You know, one of the challenges as Martin makes the second one was she going to be able to play for 30 minutes as hard and as well as she plays for 15. She's certainly on her way now, Bobby, to doing things that only we could only dream about.
25-12, Bobcats by 13. Some pressure in the backcourt. Aggie's able to bring it across at the left wing, Ariel Bercy. Watched by Martin. Throws a feed on the give and go for McCray inside. Layup attempt no good, but a foul. And Guastella wincing a bit underneath. I think she'll get the call. That'll be her second.
Well, maybe a tough whistle that time by Guastella. Good weak side help that time. And whistle didn't blow until the shot didn't go in. And I'm not a big fan of waiting to see the result before you blow.
So at the line, April McCray, sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina. Transfer from Virginia Commonwealth. Makes the first free throw.
And had a pretty good career at Virginia Commonwealth. So certainly proved she could play at that level. But wanted to get herself at a place she felt a little more comfortable. And she's going to be a big big inside player for A&T.
Yeah, a lot of fresh faces on this team. They have four transfers, four freshmen, only five returning players. The second free throw is no good off the back iron. And it's rebounded by Katie Carroll, who makes her first appearance of the season for the Bobcats. They get it to Abshire in the forecourt, dribbling at the right wing. Bobcats lead at 25-13. Ellen Cannon, far sideline, doesn't dribble, holds over ahead. Now one bounce on the dribble, needs some help. Finds McQueen, top of the circle, moves to the right side of the lane, inside for Carroll, double team, spins to her right, and the shot blocked, but they call McCray on the foul anyway.
Okay, two things on that play, very impressed with. Number one, Brittany McQueen. Brittany McQueen is able to go ahead now and play 13 minutes of a game and hasn't taken a shot. And that's not a Brittany McQueen we would have used to have been able to see. I think winning all those games, she understands what her role is. When the shot's available, she'll take it. And Katie Carroll, who whatever the amount of time she gets, might be the most productive member of this women's basketball team. She just makes the right play.
She makes the first free throw, the sophomore from Westlake, Ohio. Last year, her best game was against Bryant, but played only 18 minutes at 6 points. So in the opportunities she's gotten, and she has a lot of competition to get some playing time, she has made those minutes count.
She really has, Bobby. And even the game she plays 1 minute, she does things the right way. So good shot there as Carroll makes the second of two free throws.
It's a 14-point lead for the Bobcats at 27-13, 6:40 to go in the first half. 2-2-1 pressure by the Bobcats in the backcourt. Now they back off a bit, and Nazario brings it across the logo. Left side pass for King. Watched by Carroll to the right side. Bercy for a three-pointer at the wing. That's way off the mark. Carroll with the easy rebound, and she gives to Abshire. Abshire against Smith. Cross to the forecourt. Far sideline, dribbling with the right hand. Boom moves to the foul line. Flips to Carroll for a three-pointer straight away. That's off the back iron, no good. Rebound goes into the hand of a couple of Aggie players. Finally, Oladele able to control and gets it out to Nazario. A&T on the move. Nazario at the foul line, goes into the lane, feeds to the low post. Left side, Tracy King banks it in.
Well, broke him down off the bounce that time. Real good feed inside.
27-15, Bobcats by a dozen. Cannon, far sideline, gets it to McQueen, right of the foul line. Dribbles, looks to back in, spins. Her shot is good.
Well, real good move that time by Brittany McQueen, and is able to turn, face the defense. Time was right for McQueen to get a shot. She made the right play.
And now she's just 16 points away from 1,000 in her career. Makes it 29-15 at the 5:39 mark of the first half. A&T ball. Bercy working around Martin. Flips to her left for King. Watched by Carroll. Gets a pick. Moves around McQueen to the right of the foul line. Goes down the lane. Off the backboard. A little too hard, but got a friendly bounce off the rim.
Able to turn the corner that time. And again, like you said, spin it in off the glass. Not a lot of weak side help that time for the Bobcat defense.
29-17, Bobcats by 12. Cannon loops a pass to McQueen. Right side of the lane off the backboard. No good. McQueen able to tip the ball away, but it's controlled by Smith to 2-on-1. Smith against Abshire. Bounce to her left for Nazario. Layup attempt is good.
Good fundamental 2-on-1 play. Going to get a quick timeout here by Trish and the Quinnipiac Bobcats, and good little mini run here by A&T.
And we're going to keep it here with 5:05 to go in the first half. Quinnipiac with a 29-19 lead. Very impressive shooting performance so far. As we mentioned before, Jasmine Martin has hit all five of her shots, 4 of 4 from downtown. But now the teammates are starting to get more of a flow offensively, which is a good thing. You're not going to be able to depend on three-point shooting all 40 minutes every night.
Well, I think what happens is, you know, teams also have scholarship players, and they're going to make some adjustments on the players who are making plays. So they've done a real good job closing out on Jasmine Martin, moving out on Guastella a little bit, and now you're going to have an opportunity to see the Brittany McQueens of the world starting to make plays. You're going to get the gold rush in the game this time, and they haven't really been as productive offensively as one would have thought they might be. They still need to get in the rhythm and find the offensive player in that group. My guess and my thought is Napolitano might have to be the leader on the offensive flow with this second group.
So it's going to be a Bobcat ball. Morgan Manns on the inbound to Ostergaard as unit number two is in the lineup for the Bobcats. Ostergaard dribbles to the left wing with the left hand. Now moves to her right. Still man defense by A&T. Needs some help. Finds Warner left of the foul line. Face of the basket. Inside Ostergaard left of the lane. Backing in. Kicks it out for Morgan Manns for a three-pointer. Buries it.
Well, they talked about her, and we were here at Bobcat Madness a couple weekends ago, and Manns can shoot the basketball.
Her
freshman knocked it down.
Her first three-pointer, 32-29. Bobcats by 13, 4:30 to go in the first half. A&T ball, left corner. It is King going baseline against Oscom, has it poked away, and they say traveling against A&T. Please finish your thought, please.
Well, I'd say Jackie Oscom in the basketball game, I thought was finished before in the other one. I like to see Oscom play. Girl's been hurt for Quinnipiac. And again, Trish has now played every member of her team that is dressed. And when you do that, you get ownership, Bobby.
Jackie Oscom has been injured for two solid years, but stuck with the program. And now she's finally getting an opportunity to play, see some game time. We have a delay. The officials kind of looking at one another. The third third official at the scores table, maybe a clock issue.
The interesting thing about this team is you talked about Jackie Oscom in terms of it's a group of kids that don't ask what you can do for me. They ask what I can do for you. And when you get that flow and you get that belief in a group, that group has a real good chance to be successful.
The game clock now being adjusted to 4:24, and they took 1 second off the shot clock. So it says 29, and Morgan Manns will inbound. Still full court pressure by the A&T defense. They bounce one to Warner and a whistle off the pass. We may have a violation here off the inbounds pass. The two of the officials are discussing it. Not quite sure. Again, the clock is locked up.
She didn't give her enough room along the baseline, so that putting the clock back to 4:24 and starting to play like it never happened.
Okay, third attempt at the inbounds pass on this possession for Quinnipiac. Morgan Manns with the ball. Needs some help. Gets it out to Warner. Quickly gets it to Ostergaard. Ostergaard races to the forecourt, far sideline against King. In front of the A&T bench, drives to the right baseline, kicks to the left corner. Now Politano for three-pointer, and that's no good off the rim. Rebound batted off the sideline. Quinnipiac ball with 4:13 to go in the half.
I like what Ostergaard's done this year to her games. A lot quicker with the balls, able to dribble the ball up as a point guard, made a real good feed to Napolitano, and I think everybody felt as Napolitano shot it, it was going to fall in.
Ostergaard inbounding at the end line. Bounces one on the cut to Manns, who lays it in, and she's fouled.
Real good set out of bounds time play that time, and a real good feed by the new point guard, Nicole Ostergaard. Good pass and real good finish by Manns.
Ola Daly with the foul, her second, team's eighth. So a nice backdoor cut, and Manns will try to finish off the three-point play. Manns, a freshman from Southbury, Connecticut. The free throw is good. She has six, and it's 34-19. Bobcats by 15 with 4:05 to go in the first half. And if you look at the faces of some of the A&T players, they seem a little perplexed right now because some of the stuff that usually works for them isn't. As the shot is no good by A&T, it's taken off by Napolitano. Moving to the forecourt. Cross-court feed from Manns, right wing to Oscom. Has it batted away by King. They fight for it at the sideline. Save attempt is no good as they blew the whistle because it hit the sideline. It'll be Bobcat ball. And we'll have a timeout on the floor. 3 minutes, 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Quinnipiac 35, A&T 19 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Experience the magic of Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol in a spectacular onstage production. Join Ebenezer Scrooge on his spirited journey to Christmases past, present, and future. Revel in the sights and sounds of the season with lively dance and glorious music. Share the magic of A Christmas Carol and rediscover Christmas in your heart.
At the Schubert New Haven, Thanksgiving weekend, November 29th through December 1st. For tickets, visit Schubert.com, sponsored by the Knights of Columbus.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special, $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com.
Bob Mortali, Bill Mecca, courtside at the TD Bank Sports Center, opening game for the Quinnipiac women with a 35-19 lead. While we have a minute, let's have a quick shout-out to the Quinnipiac field hockey team winning a big semifinal game in the MAC tournament today, right?
Well, they took Bryan out 5-0, and propels Quinnipiac into the championship game tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock against either Ryder or Monmouth, who's playing tonight at 6 o'clock. So congrats to Quinnipiac Field Hockey.
Bobcats with the inbounds pass to Warner at the far sideline. Gets about to Ostergaard. 35-19 lead. Bobcats in front. Ostergaard on the drive to the right of the foul line. Pulls it back out to the right wing. Dribbling with the left hand against McCray. Or check that, Bercy. Now to give to Manns. On the curl. Six on the shot clock. Cross court. Napolitano. Left wing three-pointer around the rim. And it falls in after a slight delay. Another three-pointer for the Bobcats.
Well, good touch. Napolitano put a big smile. I love women's basketball because when they make a play, they're not afraid to smile.
Maria's first points of the season. It's 38-19. Bobcats up by the 2-1 margin here. Pass to the foul line. Knocked away from King. Loose on the floor. A tie ball this time. The possession arrow in favor of North Carolina A&T.
I think that impressed me a lot last year during the course of the season in that run by Quinnipiac, Bobby, was how well they played defensively. And that certainly has carried over. It's a team that believes in each other. They're not afraid to get on the floor. But it's a team that has confidence if they make a mistake, someone's going to be there to pick them up.
Another discussion by the officials. I give the whistle. It's going to be Quinnipiac ball as they're lining up for the full court pressure in the end line to our right.
Well, the possession arrow is pointing the other way, so I don't know how Quinnipiac was able to get the basketball back.
That left me kind of perplexed as well. Either way, it's Ostergaard dribbling in the forecourt just past us with 3 minutes to go in the first half. Left side to Warner. And there's a bump with Nazario, who just picked up another foul for A&T. Her second.
A&T has now gone small, and they're figuring they go small, maybe get a little quicker and force some turnovers. But, you know, Quinnipiac's bigs can handle the basketball. They step Warner out. You've seen Manns can handle a little bit. And certainly Ostergaard playing a point for the gold rush has been very effective.
Cameron Warner missing the first free throw. The senior from Keene, New Hampshire, 6'2", and one of the all-time leaders in block shots here at the university with 76. In her career, she ranks seventh all-time.
Well, very, very athletic, and a young lady that deeply cares about not only how she plays as she makes the free throw, but how her team plays.
39-19, Bobcats by 20. Warner with her first point of the season. Debbie Smith back in the lineup for North Carolina A&T with 2:55 to go in the first half. DeAndre Davis will run things at the point. They throw onto the far side for Smith. Left side jumper is good.
Well, one of the first clean looks that time against Quinnipiac's 2-1-2 zone. Smith was able to knock down a pass over the top.
39-21. Oscom, far sideline for Quinnipiac, moves to the right of the foul line. Gets the pass off to Manns, but it's deflected and controlled by A&T. Carter in the forecourt for the Aggies. Left side for Smith. That's a 25-footer, and she hits it off the back iron. No good. Oscom and Manns control it. It's Manns who gets the pass to Ostergaard. Throws quickly down court to Napolitano. In the low post, layup attempt, no good. Carter loses it. It's taken off by Maria. Bouncing one to Manns. Left wing three-pointer. That's off the back iron. Oscom controls now to Warner. Her layup attempt, no good. States the team to strap for it. Oscom rips it out of the hands of Ola Dele, and a whistle, and they say tie ball possession out to A&T.
Real good job that time by Oscom in the low post. Good job by Warner. A little unlucky that the ball didn't go in, but you gotta love their effort.
And you gotta like the way Jackie likes to mix it up. She's trying to make up for two lost years, and she's scrapping at every possession.
Well, she's competing, Bobby, and I think you get kids that compete, and everybody's pulling the rope in the same direction, you got a chance.
Starting lineup back in for the Bobcats with 2:06 to go in the first half and an 18-point lead at 39-21. Carter in the forecourt trying to back in on Martin. Left side pass for King. And a whistle away from the play. More contact and a foul against Quinnipiac.
And they got Martin that time off the ball holding the cutter. And I'm not sure she was holding the cutter because the cutter really didn't want the basketball. But tough whistle and one I guess Martin's got to learn to stay away from her.
That'll send Carter to the foul line as the foul, I believe, is on
Jasmine.
Oh, that's her second then. Free throw attempt is no good on the 1-1. Ball loose, goes out of bounds at the far corner. And they're going to say blue ball. So it's A&T with a 18-point deficit and a minute 53 to go in the first half. It'll be Debbie Smith to throw in. On the sideline, not in the end line, right in the corner, however, as she gets it out to Bercy. Bercy's watched by Cannon. Bercy to the left wing. Gets around a pick. Picked up by McQueen momentarily. Now Cannon gets it back. Left side pass Smith. Drives to the left baseline. Cross-court feed. Lost control. Kings forces up a shot and makes it.
Good finish that time down there low by A&T. A&T's starting to get a little loose down there in a low post. And getting some baskets.
39-23 with a minute and a half to go first half. Abshire right at the foul line is a collision. Both players go down. Foul called. Looks like A&T this time as Oladele very frustrated with the officiating on that sequence. That's her third, by the way.
Well, she might be frustrated, but she ran Abshire over. So, I understand. It was a foul, regardless if they played last year's rules or this year's rules. Anytime you run into a ball handler, they're going to blow the whistle.
Boo Abshire with the free throw to our left makes the first. Swished it home. Her first point of the game, 40-23. Now Warner's back in for Carroll. And for A&T, it'll be April McCray for Oladele. 1:28 to go first half. Bobcats lead it 40-23. One more free throw for Boo. It's in the air. It is good. The lead is 18, 41-23. Carter takes her time, bringing it across the logo. Stops her dribble. Feet inside, stolen by Napolitano. No a Aggie player anywhere near the pass. And it's Quinnipiac ball. Abshire inside. Warner all alone underneath. She banks it in.
Real good feed that time, but I love the play by the free safety that time. Napolitano got off her defender and went and stole the ball like Randy Merriweather of the Redskins was able to lead it up for a fast break basket.
The lead is 20 again, 43-23. And on the other end, a foul on Cameron Warner. She tied up with King. 58 seconds to go in the first half. The lead is 20.
Well, you watch defenders, and it's like having a dog with one of those collars on it, electric fence. And once you step outside, you get shocked. And I think what they're trying to teach defenders is, if you're close, I'm going to blow it, and habitually get them to realize I've got to back up.
Free throw for King at the basket to our right. The free throw's off the back iron. No good. Carroll gets a nice positioning inside for the rebound and controls the Bobcats. He gives to McQueen, who hands to Abshire. Boo racing to the forecourt to the left wing with 50 seconds to go in the first half. Bobcats by 20. Abshire between the circles. Bounces one for Cannon on the left wing. Feet inside for McQueen. Tries to move against the double team. Lost control. It's poked away. McQueen on the floor gets it back to Cannon. Her three-pointer left wing is good.
Well, she shot that right in our lap that time. Real good job by McQueen, who loses it, flips it out, and Ellen Cannon from 37 feet knocks it down.
Just seemed that way, though, folks. It's her second three-pointer of the half. 46-23. Bobcats with a big lead. 20 seconds to go. A&T ball. King inside. Pass knocked away. Controlled by Cannon. One last possession for the Bobcats. Abshire across the logo with 12 seconds to go. She lets the clock roll as she takes her time, gives directions. 7 seconds to go. Moves to her left on Debbie Smith. Left of the foul line, in the lane, spins. One-hander, turnaround, 2-hour off the backboard. It's on the floor. McQueen forces one from the foul line. No good, but a terrific first half for the Quinnipiac women in the season opener. Lead by 23 points as we go to the locker room. It's a well-oiled machine that hasn't missed a beat from last season, it seems.
Well, you know what? They got the right recipe, and if you don't change the ingredients and you continue to follow the recipe, you got a chance, and that's what this women's basketball team has certainly done last year. And, Bobby, they have indeed carried it over, an incredible run in the first half by Quinnipiac.
So we are at the half here at the TD Bank Sports Center. It is Quinnipiac 46, North Carolina A&T 23. We'll be right back.
How did I get here? Dumb luck? Or good decisions? About marriage? Children? Money? About tomorrow?
Who matters most to you says the most about you. At MassMutual, we're owned by our policy owners, and they matter most to us. Learn more at massmutual.com/mutuality. Ready to plan for your family's future?
Get your coffee from the folks that know coffee, inside and out. For over 60 years, we've kept America running with our dedication to serving the freshest cup of coffee. Dunkin' Donuts. America runs on Dunkin'. You want your coffee quick, freshly brewed, and ground from only the finest beans. Make the most of your day with the fresh ground taste of America's favorite cup of joe. At Dunkin' Donuts, you can do it. Dunkin' Donuts coffee. America runs on Dunkin'.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. 4 mornings a week, I try to get a run in. And I know that I'm supposed to drink a glass of water after my run, but there's the Dunkin' Donuts right on the way home.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. When you get that first cup of coffee in the morning, it starts your day off right. You know, pre-coffee, you should keep your distance. Once I have my Dunkin', I'm all good.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
The atmosphere is festive here at the TD Bank Sports Center. We're at halftime of the season opener for the Quinnipiac women. The Bobcats have been pretty dominant here in the first half, leading 46-23. Let's update you first on the weekend sports schedule here at Quinnipiac. Coming up in about an hour and 15 minutes, the Bobcat hockey team looking for its ninth win in a row. They'll take on Brown just across the concourse here at the Ice Arena. Tomorrow, the men open in Bridgeport, first of the Connecticut 6 Classic. They'll play the University of Hartford at 3 o'clock. The six non-UConn Division I teams with their annual get-together down at the Western Bank Arena at Bridgeport. And then the game of the year on the hockey schedule, at least, tomorrow night here at the TD Bank Sports Center. Across the way, the rematch of the national title game, Yale and Quinnipiac, gets underway at 7 o'clock. It's tough to be everywhere all at once, Bill, but if you're a Quinnipiac fan, you're in heaven this weekend.
Well, you really are, you know. And again, the Yale-Quinnipiac hockey game, certainly coming off it was an extraordinary run by Quinnipiac hockey last year, and losing to Yale in the Frozen Four Championship certainly adds a new meaning. The unfortunate part with that game is it's November 9th.
That's
right.
You know,
and it's a game historically that's run in February. The ECAC flips the schedule up every 2 years, and now the rotation is it's early. So you got to make it, take it, do what you got to do, and certainly Quinnipiac is looking forward to that rematch.
And, of course, the secret word in the locker room is payback, because although they beat them three times last season, it's the last of the four that counts the most and the one that's going to stay in their minds until they face them again tomorrow night.
Well, there's no doubt, you know, and they certainly have it on their mind. And, again, they got their nemesis tonight in Brown. And, you know, again, Quinnipiac has got to not be able to look past Brown. They've been playing really good. I've had a chance to watch them a couple times. I've seen you over there, and it's an incredible group of seniors led by the Jones brothers and Jordan Samuel Thomas, that they're playing at a level early in the year that I've never really seen before.
And diamond in the rough, Sam Annis, a freshman who is one of the leading goal scorers in the country, a little guy, but with a big heart.
He plays hard. He's in the right place at the right time. And any chance you get to play with the Jones brothers, you pick up, you play a little bit, you're going to have chances. And he's been able to knock them in the net.
Well, there's a lot happening that's new here this year in the basketball program as well. Let's first start talking about this brand new scoreboard that I'm sure you had a lot to do with in terms of getting a HD quality video replay, or actually during the game. Sometimes you're torn if it's in the stands. Do I watch the players on the floor, or do I watch them on the big screen above us? Tell us about that scoreboard.
Well, you know, I think it's another commitment by the institution to add credibility to a place that's been thriving. And you can't help but notice as you walk in now, you know, Quinnipiac invested over $3.5 million on two state-of-the-art scoreboards, 6mm HD, which is unheard of in the world of not only in college athletics, but in professional athletics. You look at Fenway, you look at Yankee Stadium, some of the new facilities are all dealing in the 8mm. Quinnipiac went ahead, committed to 6mm. It's state-of-the-art. And, Bobby, there's nothing about it that doesn't turn around and say big time. And for an institution that continues to grow, it'd be hard-pressed to find a place that is any better and bigger with the commitment John Leahy makes to this institution.
There are also four very narrow but digital boards in the four corners of the arena, including a nice long one at the base of the luxury seating in the upper deck to our right, enhancing the program. Their logos going across it right now, both the basketball logo and the Bobcat logo. Also new this year, new conference, Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference. Conference play begins in early December. What kind of benefits does that bring the program in terms of moving to a higher-ranked conference? Their RPI was 14 last year, while Northeast was 20.
I think it's very clear in terms of the mission, in terms of what happens institutional-wise. Quinnipiac, under John Leahy, had made a determination and a decision that once we got the academics in place, once we go ahead and elevated the business school, you get the law school, you get the medical school, and now you see a program that's strong, you have an opportunity to raise your athletic program. The move to the MAC will increase your visibility. It will also enhance your credibility, not only regionally but nationally. It'll put you in a league with institutions that have been playing basketball for well over 100 years, and it does nothing more than to add the fact that this is one incredible institution.
And one of the things that the MAC tells its members to do is to toughen up your non-conference schedule. So we're seeing both programs play bigger names opponents. Next year, the women go to South Bend, Indiana as part of a tournament there. They're in the WNIT this year. The guys are playing Oregon State at the end of December. I'm going to make that trip. So a lot of, you know, frontline teams are going to become regular Quinnipiac opponents.
Well, it is. And again, that's going to add more fan support. It's going to get people more interested in what goes on, I think, on the basketball court. And you know, you go from there, but you certainly now have seen just this past summer with women's basketball and men's basketball, the level of recruit that now is committed to Quinnipiac during the upcoming NLI timing, which will be next week, you've opened yourself up to kids that might not have paid attention to Quinnipiac because now you're part of a league. And young kids right now elevate to a league, and Quinnipiac now is in a league, basketball-wise and the other sports, that say, you know what, they're a player not only in the classroom but on the court as well.
They certainly are. So big things expected here at Quinnipiac for hockey and basketball. We mentioned field hockey a few moments ago. Women's hockey doing very well also this year, almost as good as the men so far, so they're making their mark. So this has the makings, a real fun winter again here up on the hill here at the TD Bank Sports Center. We are at halftime. It's Quinnipiac leading at 46-23. Paul Pacelli's in the studio tonight. Scoreboard update comes your way next on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Take a trip down the aisle you'll never forget at Mamma Mia, Broadway's smash hit musical based on the songs of ABBA. Everyone's having the time of their lives at this guaranteed get happy hit about a mother, her daughter, and three possible dads. How can you resist?
See Mamma Mia at the Schubert New Haven, November 22nd through 24th. For tickets, visit Schubert.com. Sponsored by Lexus and Whitney Center.
After nearly 50 years serving the community with all your lighting needs, the Lamp Shop will be closing their doors forever on December 28th. I'm Jackie Kaywood, and I want to thank all of you who have supported the Lamp Shop. You have not just been customers, you have been my friends as well. Throughout the years, I have offered great specials on all our beautiful lighting merchandise, but never have the specials been this spectacular. Now through December 28th, I'm holding a retirement sale with an additional 50% off all merchandise, excluding lampshades, parts, and repairs. The Lamp Shop, 993 Dixwell Avenue in Hamden, open Tuesday through Saturday. Thank you for your patronage and your friendship.
The Lamp Shop will be closing their doors forever on December 28th. Join Jackie at a retirement sale and take an additional 50% off all merchandise, excluding lampshades, parts, and repairs.
Experience the magic of Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol in a spectacular onstage production. Join Ebenezer Scrooge on his spirited journey to Christmases past, present, and future. Revel in the sights and sounds of the season with lively dance and glorious music. Share the magic of A Christmas Carol and rediscover Christmas in your heart.
At the Schubert New Haven, Thanksgiving weekend, November 29th through December 1st. For tickets, visit Schubert.com, sponsored by the Knights of Columbus.
And then we are back here in the Bobcats Radio Network. Paul Pacelli with your halftime scoreboard update. The Quinnipiac women picking up right where they left off of last year's NCAA tournament effort, as the Bobcats lead North Carolina A&T at the half of this first game of the preseason women's NIT. The score of Quinnipiac 46 and North Carolina A&T 23, so the Bobcat women doubling up A&T in the first half. Now, if the Bobcats go on and win this game, they will play Sunday side in opposition to be determined. If they lose, they'll play Friday, but that'll all get hashed out in the next few days. So once again, Quinnipiac with a 46-23 lead at the half against North Carolina A&T. Now, coming up tomorrow in Bridgeport, this year's edition of the Connecticut Six, finding the Quinnipiac men opening up against the University of Hartford. That's 2:30 pregame, the 3 o'clock opening tip. Bob Mortali will have that action as the men get their schedule underway. And then the men travel to LaSalle to Philadelphia Tuesday morning for an early morning matchup. That's a 9 o'clock tip at 8:30 pregame on AM 1220 WQUN and WQUN.com, as the Bobcat men take part of the 24-hour madness, kind of the opening day thing for college basketball by ESPN. So it's Quinnipiac and LaSalle coming up on Tuesday morning. As Bob and Billy mentioned a couple of minutes ago, men's hockey, another big weekend. 7 o'clock face-off tonight against Brown of the High Point Solutions Arena. Tomorrow night, 7 o'clock face-off against Yale, a replay of the, or matchup of the two teams that played for the national title last year. Pre-game shows both nights at 6:30 right here on AM 1220 WQUN and WQUN.com. And a big salute once again to the Quinnipiac women's field hockey team. An earlier win today, 5-0 against Bryant in the MAC semifinals. So the Bobcats move to the MAC title game coming up tomorrow against the winner of the other MAC semi that's being played tonight. NBA tonight, Celts on the road at Orlando, Brooklyn's on the road at Washington, the Knicks on the road to take on Charlotte, National Hockey League, New Jersey on the road to take on Toronto. Top 25 college football action tonight, UConn still winless at home and on the season as a whole at the Rent to take on number 20 Louisville. And back to men's college basketball, number 18 preseason UConn, the UConn men take on Maryland. That game is at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. A couple of other sports notes to the NHL. Kevin Dineen has been dismissed as coach of the Florida Panthers. The Panthers are losing seven straight and currently stand 14th in the 16-team Eastern Conference. Dineen in three seasons was 56-62-28 as the head man there in Florida. Once again, we are at the half. The Quinnipiac women leading North Carolina A&T 46-23. We'll get you back up top of the hill. Bob Mortali and Billy Mecca. Second half action is coming up right after this.
Are you an early bird or a night owl? Well, TD Bank is both. You see, TD Bank is open longer than other banks. That means mighty early and mighty late. Of course, you can always visit them online at tdbank.com or give them a ring at 888-751-9000. Because you can talk to an actual person 24/7, 365 days a year. It's part of what they call banking human. And it's why TD Bank is America's most convenient bank. Member FDIC, TD Bank NA.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year at the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. The Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Stay in touch with all the latest Bobcats news at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Everything you ever want to know about all 21 Quinnipiac University athletic teams. The latest results, stats on the players, feature stories on the athletes, and action photos. It's all yours at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Bookmark it as one of your favorites. QuinnipiacBobcats.com.
Quinnipiac basketball exclusively on AM 1220 WQUN Hamden. Ride home with Steve Savino, afternoons from 4 to 6.
We are back at the TD Bank Sports Center. Bob Mortali and Bill Mecca, season opener and the opening round of the preseason WNIT for the Quinnipiac women. Bobcats, an impressive first half, leading 46-23. There isn't a bad number on the ledger for these Quinnipiac women in the box score in the first half.
No, it really isn't. It's a clean sheet, 10 for 15 from threes, and led by a clean sheet by Jasmine Martin, who's 5 for 5, 4 threes, and, you know, 16 points early. So I think the impressive thing, Bobby, 14 made baskets by Quinnipiac, obviously 10 three-pointers on that, but 14 assists. So it hasn't been done selfishly. It's been a team unit. It's been a team group, and it's a team that really is bought into the same formula that gave them all those wins last year.
19-12 rebounding edge, and 8 out of 9 from the foul line. That was one of the Achilles heels of this team last year. They shot about 63% from the foul line. I heard Trish Fabry talk at a practice recently saying we need to increase our free throw percentage about 10% to compete in the MAC, and, you know, that's going to be a big factor in some of these close conference games down the road.
Well, I think if you're shooting the ball really well from 10 for 15 from threes, pretty good chance when you get to the foul line, those same kids are going to make free throws. So it's a team that really has shot it well tonight. Now the question becomes, they played exceptional basketball for 20 minutes. Can they keep their game elevated to that pace, or are they going to have a little bit of game slippage? I'm curious to find out.
It'll be Samantha Guastella just in front of our location here to throw in at the midcourt line. Regular starting five for the Bobcats. McQueen, Abshire, Martin, and Cannon in the lineup with Guastella. We're ready to go. Quinnipiac will go from left to right here in the second half, and we are underway passing the backcourt to Abshire. Boo with the logo, moving to her left, stops, bounces one to Cannon in front of the Bobcat bench. Left side of the lane, McQueen, she spins, looks on the drive, throws up a one-hand floater, no good off the backboard, rebound tipped around, collision with about three or four players. The officials say, let's go down the other end. It's a foul against Quinnipiac.
Well, I love the adjustment A&T makes this possession to start the second half, which was really tough man-to-man defense on the perimeter, which is going to give McQueen an opportunity to play well inside. Real good move, just didn't finish.
McQueen's foul, her first. It's the A&T ball in the forecourt. King to the right side for Debbie Smith. Fakes the three-pointer, goes inside the arc, and tries from two. It's off the back iron, no good. Abshire with a rebound. She's got a two-on-one break. Right side pass for Cannon. Long two-point shot. That's off the back iron, no good. It wasn't going to be a three-pointer anyway. And rebounded to McCray. She looks to her left for Nazario. Nazario in the forecourt, dribbles to the left wing. Moving to her left by the sideline, watched by Jasmine Martin. The Quinnipiac leads 46-23 in the first minute of the second half. Nazario moves to the foul line, kicks it to the right corner for Tracy King. Long jumper is good.
Good set, good kick out that time, and good dribble penetration to an open receiver in the corner.
She has 8 points, and it's 46-25. Bobcat ball, Abshire forecourt, cross the way, dribbles now to the foul line, backs it out. Loops one of the low posts for McQueen. She's double-teamed, and a whistle and a foul call against the Aggies. Abra McCray's third personal, team's first.
Well, feed inside, little body that time on McQueen, and couldn't make a move because they called a foul.
Inbounds pass intended for McQueen, tipped away by McCray, loose on the floor as Bursey goes down, tied up with Abshire, and the foul's going to be called on the Bobcats. It's going to be against Boo, her first, team second.
A little sloppy play early on for Quinnipiac, and A&T's come out a little feisty to start the second half.
Minute 15 gone by, second half, Bobcats lead 46-25. Nazario for King in the forecourt. To the right side, Smith in front of the A&T bench, moves to her left around the three-point arc, on top for King. King's watched by Guastella. Moving now to her right, around McQueen to the right wing. Bounce inside McCrane, a bump with Abshire, and a foul's going to be called. The layup is no good, but Boo just picked up another foul. That'll be her second.
A&T making a little good run here, and I think A&T is going to play pretty hard now for the course of the next 2 or 3 minutes. And the trouble they're going to have, Bobby, is it's really hard to go ahead and make a dent on a team that has a 23, 24-point lead. They're up 21 now because it's going to take a Quinnipiac 3 to get A&T discouraged again.
McCray makes the first. She had 3 points in the first half and one of two from the foul line in the first 20 minutes of action. 46-26. Bobcats by 20. Taking her time on the second free throw attempt. A little less trajectory that time. It's no good. And it's rebounded by Brittany McQueen. Out to Abshire. Abshire to the forecourt right wing. To the right corner, Cannon. Fakes the three-pointer. Kicks it back out for Abshire. To McQueen. Left of the foul line. Left side, Martin. On the drive. Back to McQueen near the foul line. Kicks it back out for Abshire. She moves to the foul line in the lane. The force of the pass. There is contact inside. Another foul. And Tracy King can't believe the call. Has both hands on the top of her head with a surprise expression on her face. Aggies get the foul call. Now McCray comes out and Ola Daly comes back in for North Carolina A&T. Bobcats lead by 20, 46-26. Abshire on the end line, inside from McQueen. Quick shot is around the rim and falls through. They're going to call an offensive foul, however, against Brittany as she collided with Nazario.
Well, not a real good whistle that time, you know. And again, a point of emphasis is also not going to allow a secondary defender to slide underneath an offensive player for a charge. So that goes against the new rule as she clearly didn't give McQueen an opportunity to fall down.
So the basket does not count. It's a 20-point lead for Quinnipiac with 2 minutes have gone by in the first, or rather the second half. Nazario moves to her right, backs it up to the logo against Jasmine Martin. Martin pokes away, but Nazario able to recover, dribbling to the A&T bench, cross the way, now to the right baseline, pull up for about a 14-footer is good.
You can see there, you know, Jazz Martin made it a point with two personal fouls not to put her hand on the ball handler, and the ball handler was able to turn the corner and make a play.
46-28 on the other end. Quinnipiac with the ball. Foul call against A&T. You know, we saw in the first half a lot of fouls caught quickly, but as the half progressed, the number of fouls seems to have backed off. We're starting off with a lot of fouls in the early going here.
Well, because A&T's putting pressure on the perimeter, and now it's a game where you're looking inside to get the ball to McQueen. And now they're starting to pay attention to post defense, and in the first half, they were paying attention to the perimeter. So it's a little too tight down there for anybody's rhythm, especially sitting over here and the fans in general.
DeAndre Davis back in, the senior from Cephna, Florida for A&T. Abshire on the inbounds, gives to McQueen, goes back to Abshire, left of the lane, a bloop inside, overthrows McQueen. She's able to save it, banks it off of Davis's leg, out of bounds. Quinnipiac keeps possession.
Good effort by McQueen that time. On a not a great feed that time by Abshire, but good finish, and Quinnipiac gets the ball back.
Bobcats lead at 46-28, season opener. Martin on the end line for Quinnipiac. Inbounds for McQueen on the right side. Gives it out for Abshire. Top of the circle. Bounces one to the left for Martin. On the drive, floater's good.
Boy, she came off of that screen that time. Curl cut and was able to go ahead and shoot that running one-hander in the lane.
18 points for Martin, and it is 48-28. The lead back to 20. Smith in the forecourt for A&T. Moves to her left around Guastella. Left corner for Bercy on the drive on the baseline. Shot is short off the rim. Foul called. It'll be a shooting foul against the Bobcats. Brittany McQueen's third personal. She's picked up all three fouls in the first 3 minutes or so of the second half. And the second five about to come in at the next opportunity. Bercy back on the foul line. 13 points last year against South Carolina State, one of her better outings of the season in the Mideast Athletic Conference. A&T was 22-10 a year ago. First free throw is no good. So it's Warner, Manns, Napolitano, Ostergaard, and Martucci in the lineup for Quinnipiac, taking out the starting five.
A chance for Martucci to play some minutes this time now. Made a run in the first half and then became a victim of getting the rest of the team in the game as she makes a free throw.
So Bercy's first point of the day, one of two from the line. It's 48-29. Inbounds to Ostergaard, double team momentarily in the backcourt, finds Manns wide open. Cross court to the, or the forecourt pass to Martucci. Far sideline, now left of the lane for Morgan Manns, left wing. One dribble, no look pass from Martucci, left baseline. The feet of the foul line from Warner is knocked away, controlled by the Aggies. Smith dribbles past us to the forecourt. Davis, left corner. One dribbles back to Smith. Smith moves to her right between the circles. Right side pass from Nazario. 16:35 left second half. Nazario dribbling with the left hand. Left corner pass for Davis. Davis moves to her right. Along the three-point arc, bounces one out toward Bercy. 10 on the shot clock. Bercy dribbles to her left. Tries to split two defenders. Finds Nazario. Left corner jumper is good for three.
A&T's taking it to Quinnipiac to start this half now. They've been able to go ahead and get this thing into a comfortable distance, 16 points. So a little run by A&T, and Bobcats haven't scored in a little while.
48-32. Ostergaard on the acceleration at the half-court line is bumped by A&T, and it's Bercy's foul, her second. 14 fouls now on A&T here in the second half. And just one bucket for the Bobcats in the first and nearly 4 minutes of the second half. That by Martin. Everybody else is scoreless. 48-32. Bobcats by 16. Inbounds to goes to Ostergaard. At the logo. Watched by Davis. Dribbling to her left. Now comes back to her right. Looking to spin. Top of the three-point circle. Continues to dribble with the left hand. Spins in the lane. Big step to drive. Banks it in. She's fouled.
Good move time by Ostergaard that time, controlling the ball up top, really overplaying the wings and the post defenders. And Ostergaard just made a 360 spin, got it inside, and little push, chance for a three-point play.
Took that trademark big step of hers before she got the shot off. We have a stoppage of play, timeout called. 15:52 remaining, second half. It is Quinnipiac 50 and A&T 32. We'll be right back.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want to sleep with her. 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 I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Damn. Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories. Maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch.
Whoops.
Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa. Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Back here at the TD Bank Sports Center, Quinnipiac still in control with an 18-point lead here in the second half. And A&T now starting to have a little concern with foul trouble. Two of their players have four fouls, April McCray and Tepetope Oladele, each with four. So that will be a concern for them as they continue to try to bounce some kind of comeback bid.
Well, you have a consistent. To get a comeback, it has to be consistent. Now, they've made a real good run over the course of the last 4 minutes, but they committed some fouls along the way. So it's going to be hard to go ahead and climb all the way back up and look for Quinnipiac now to get back to business here. First time we've seen now a little bit of game slippage by the Bobcats, and I think you're up 25-26. You head in that locker room at halftime. Human nature is a terrible opponent, and you got a chance to let down a little bit.
Ostergaard at the foul line. Last year, one of her best performances, 13 points against the Red Storm of St. John's. Looking at the basket to our right, and she makes a free throw to complete the three-point play to give Quinnipiac a 51-32 advantage. 15:50 to go in the second half. Winner tonight gets the winner of Louisville against Loyola Chicago. That quarterfinal game will be Monday night. King with the basketball, splits two defenders, goes down the lane, is a block from behind by Warner, taken up by Ostergaard. She gets tied up in traffic, and a reach-in foul is going to be called on the Aggies. Looks like it'll go against Tracy King. It'll be her third.
What happens, Bobby, in a game of basketball as a player, you're down 16 points. You get a little bit of a run. You look at the scoreboard, and now you're down again by, 21 points. You're like, we don't have a chance.
Ostergaard finds Warner, right wing, goes inside Napolitano, right low post, got position. She scores. She's fouled.
Yeah, real good feed that time, and good finish by Napolitano.
Adriana Nazaro picks up the foul, her third. And so Maria with an opportunity to complete a three-point play at a 14-point outing against Monmouth last year. Four three-pointers in that one. In the air, back iron, no good after hits the rim a second time, and Debbie Smith gets the rebound for North Carolina A&T. It's Quinnipiac 53, A&T 32, 15:20 to go, second half. Carter's pass deflected, but Smith controls at the right wing. Moves to her left, picked up by Warner. Right side pass for Bursey. Bursey on the move, right side of the lane. Scoop layup is good.
Well, pretty good quick move that time by Bursey. She's able to turn the corner and flip it up with one hand.
53-34, Bobcats by 19. Ostergaard far sideline. Switches hands on the dribble, spins to the foul line, tied up momentarily, able to control from Morgan Mance for a shot, put three-pointer and buries it.
Well, I tell you what, she wound up like a little TikTok and was able to head and knock that thing down.
Shot that from the shoulder, but that's her second three of the afternoon. 56-34, Bobcats lead 22. 14:40 left second half. Carter. Spinning on Martucci between the circles, moves to her left, gets a pick from King, lost control of the ball, able to settle it down, gets it to Bursey. Top of the three-point arc, right side Debbie Smith, drives to the foul line. Pull-up jumper is around the rim, falls in, and she'll go to the free throw line. Smith now with seven.
A&T's offense now has turned into, they're going to go ahead and play one-on-one a little bit, look to put it on the floor, go by you, and then shoot the basketball. And they've had some success with that and get to the foul line. And Smith, who's not a bad player, has a chance for a three-point play.
Ostergaard's foul, her second personal, team sixth. The free throw attempt is off the front rim, no good by Smith. Mans with the rebound, able to muscle it away from a defender, takes it out and gets it to Ostergaard. Ostergaard to the forecourt right wing. Left side from Mans, left corner Martucci has it knocked away off the hands of Carter. So it's Quinnipiac ball.
I like how Mans plays. She's a little feisty. I like everything about her, good high school player and is able to play at this level, no doubt.
Inbound for Ostergaard, 14:25 left second half. Bobcats lead at 56-36. Nikki on the drive, past the foul line, hits the floater, but they say before the shot, foul call again against A&T.
These new rules are going to hurt Ostergaard because she's so clever with the ball and has that long step. She's never going to be able to get to the rim because any touch is going to be a foul, and she's going to get to the foul line now. And at the 14:27-minute mark, A&T is already in the bonus.
Ostergaard back at the foul line, makes the first. Nikki now with 4 points here in the second half. The substitution, DeAndre Davis, returning to the A&T lineup, replacing Bursey. Second free throw in the air, and it is off the back iron, no good. Nazario gets the loose rebound for A&T. Moves to the foul line, kicks it to the left for Davis. Mans almost knocked it away, but it's saved for Smith. Out on top for King, three-pointer straight away. That's too hard back iron. Ball batted around. It's controlled by the Aggies inside. Carter goes up with it. That's knocked away, but a foul call against Quinnipiac.
Wow. I can't even explain what just happened there, Bobby, other than foul inside by Cameron Warner on a ball that had been passed clearly 2 seconds before she got called.
So Warner's third personal foul. Team sixth. Bobcats by 21 as Carter goes to the line. Now there'll be a little discussion, maybe a clarification of the call. They want to confirm whether it's a one-on-one or not, I think. Actually, the official had two fingers up. By the way, our officials, we didn't introduce them in the first half. Richard Wright, Deb Garcia, and Randall Amy.
Certainly familiar with Deb Garcia. She's been around a little bit and seen her, but not familiar with the other two gentlemen.
I remember Richard Amy a couple of times in some of the games I've done, maybe on the road trips.
Oh, okay.
14:27 to go in the second half. The discussion, either foul or a clock. The game clock says 14:27. The game clock on the shot clock scoreboard says 13:52. So there's our discrepancy.
Yeah, I would say that's a pretty good size discrepancy, right?
Yeah, absolutely. If you're down 21 or so, you need every second you can get. So 30 might help.
Yeah, 29-second difference, and I'm not sure they've noticed that the clock is still different because they haven't made any adjustments.
In any event, it is Carter with a free throw tip. It's good. Her second point of the afternoon, now evening, since it's quarter after 6. And with one more coming. You know, I think the scoreboard is locked, too, because we have it as 57-36. Second free throw, no good. Warner with the rebound. And it's Bobcats ball. Ostergaard rather dribbles behind her back on the backcourt. Now gets to the Warner. Quickly up court to Napolitano. Right corner three-pointer around the rim. No good. Man's a great position on the rebound. Her pass attempt, though, deflected by A&T. It's controlled by the Aggies. It is Nazario racing up court. Has it knocked away almost by Martucci from behind as the starting five come off the bench for Quinnipiac. Nazario between the circles. Moves to her left. Throws the pass to her right for Carter. Out of the right corner for Davis. Bounces one of the low posts. It is loose and is picked up by Cameron Warner. Out for Ostergaard as a reach and foul in the backcourt against Nazario. So the overhead scoreboard still says 14:27 on that clock, while the shot clock above the game clock rather above the shot clock has 13:16. Nazario's fourth foul, by the way.
Well, clearly the one you're looking at is going to look at the one on the shot clock at 13:16 because you look at the corners, you really can't see, and 13:16 is the number. So, Bob, you got to keep track of the score, and then we'll go from there.
Okay, at least our table computer seems to be accurate in terms of the number is 57-37, so we go with that until we hear otherwise.
Makes sense.
For the starters back in, as Ostergaard will take the free throw, she'll be replaced by Abshire at the next opportunity. One official went over to A&T coach Terrell Robinson to tell him, yeah, we're aware of the shot clock problem. There are new auxiliary scoreboards in the tunnels to our left and right so he can keep track of the time that way. So the bench over there knowing now that the overhead scoreboard is malfunctioning at the moment. So it's Ostergaard at the free throw line. Go ahead.
No, I'm good. It's just you're able to look at the beautiful picture in high def as Ostergaard misses the free throw.
Ball is loose near the end line. It's controlled by the Aggies, and it's Carter who will bring it across the forecourt for North Carolina A&T. 57-37, Bobcats by 20. Nazario for Carter for a three-pointer. That's good. First field goal for Carter. She has 5 points, and it's 57-40. Now the overhead scoreboard clock is finally in sync with the clocks on the shot clock. So it's 12:47 to go in the second half. Ostergaard, a loop inside from McQueen in the left low post. Double team, tied up momentarily. Got a hit in the face, it looked like. Able to get the pass off for Guastella. Now Cannon, right wing, near sideline. Bounces one back for Guastella. Right side low post. Turnaround one-hander is good.
Well, real good feed that time by Cannon. Really unselfish that time. She gets the pass back. And I've always liked to reward the post player with a pass. Give it back to her. Good move by Sam.
59-40, Bobcats by 19, 12:20 remaining in the second half. Nice round number for the radio station, by the way. Nazario on the right wing, moves to her left around the three-point perimeter. Right side pass for Smith. Watched by Ostergaard. Out on top for Davis. She's guarded by Cannon. Right side Smith, three-pointer from there, is off the front of the rim, no good. Guastella with the easy rebound for Quinnipiac. Sets it up for Ostergaard. Nikki looking down court for Cannon on the drive. Right baseline. Layup attempt blocked from behind and out of bounds. Last touch by A&T. I believe it was Nazario got a hand on the ball and knocked it away. So with Abshire returning to the game and Ostergaard leaving, there's a timeout on the floor. 11:55 remaining. Second half. It's Quinnipiac 59 and A&T 40 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Has life passed you by with work, home, bills, responsibilities? How about a break for you? This is Dan Darling. I want you to be inspired today through coffeebreakforthesoul.com. You can read a text, watch a video, even journal your own thoughts or share a thought. So come and be inspired today through coffeebreakforthesoul.com. Subscribe today.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special. $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com.
For a season debut, the Bobcats have looked very sharp here in the opening night against North Carolina A&T, and it's 59-40. Quinnipiac with the lead on the Aggies. Again, a reminder, when we're done here, those of you listening on the web, stick around. We'll have the Bobcat hockey game for you against Brown as soon as our postgame show is over, and the Bobcats looking for their ninth win in a row against the team that gave a lot of fits last year, the Brown Bears.
Now, fortunately, that goalie who gave Quinnipiac a lot of fits over the course of the last 4 years has graduated. So you'll play with a new guy in net, and maybe Quinnipiac's luck will change.
Bobcat ball, Abshire to inbound on the end line. Bounces one right low post to McQuain. Gives it back to Abshire. Baseline jumper no good. McQuain, though, with the rebound, goes back to Boo. She dribbles to the right of the foul line. Spins on the drive. No shot in the whistle before the shot got off. And a foul is going to be called on the Aggies. And she came very close to traveling, by the way, on that play.
Well, she really did. But again, with the whistles being blown the way they're blowing, I mean, it's going to be really, it's going to be hard for A&T to get back in the basketball game. And all in college basketball, if you fall behind, it's going to be nearly impossible if she misses a free throw to get back in the game, because any touch is going to put your opponent on an unguarded 15-foot set shot.
Abshire misses the first free throw. The second one also off the back iron, no good, and it's taken off by the Aggies. Christina Carter picked up her second foul, and A&T now at 10 team fouls for the second half. In the forecourt, on the baseline, Nazario fakes the shot, goes out for Carter. They go to the right side now in the corner. It's King for a three-pointer. That's off the rim, no good. Rebound 4-4 inside, controlled by Nazario. And she'll bring it back out to the left wing with a fresh shot clock. 11:25 left second half. Bobcats lead at 59-40. Bursey to the right corner for King. On the baseline, kicks it back out. Carter, left wing, goes into the lane. Trips up a running one-hander around the rim. Doesn't fall in. McQuain got a handle on the rebound, but it's controlled by A&T. They kick it back out for Bursey. Right corner, now finds Carter. Carter will set it up from between the circles. Left side, Nazario. Three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. McQuain with a rebound, and just before the pass was sent down court, foul call on the Aggies.
Yeah, those are the ones the officials need to figure out if they're really fouls. I mean, because what happens now is you've really taken an opportunity on a great two-handed rebound by McQuain and a great outlet pass to a streaking Jasmine Martin wide open for a shot, and you've eliminated that from the fans watching the game of college basketball. You've taken a rebound, you got a touch, and now you go to the foul line, and it is going to turn people off when it comes time to, do I really want to go watch this game?
DeAndre Davis with the foul. As McQuain makes the first, Davis' first personal foul. And for Brittany, that's her third point of the game, the first from the line. Second free throw good as well. And it is 61-40. Bobcats back by 21. A&T ball. Cannon guarding Carter. Right side pass from Nazario, front of the A&T bench. She's double-teamed momentarily. Cross-court feed for Bursey and a traveling call against A&T.
Well, first whistle, that wasn't a foul we've seen in the second half. So we have not seen a real good flow, Bobby, in the second half because we've had a lot of game stoppage.
We certainly have. Abshire in the backcourt for Quinnipiac. She moves it past us to the forecourt. Watch closely by Carter. Spinning at the right wing. Bloops one inside from McQuain. She's double-teamed, almost fouled from behind, but it's stolen by Bursey. Gets it out to Nazario. Nazario across the logo of the forecourt at the right wing. Now she's straight away facing two defenders. As Quinnipiac looks like going to zone here. Nazario, right side for Bursey in front of the A&T bench. The feed inside King. Pump fakes. Double team. Out for Nazario at the foul line. Now to Bursey. Right wing. Shot clock at 9. Martin steals a ball for Quinnipiac. She lost control of it. It's Cannon trying to save it at the logo and does so. Bounces one on her knees to Martin. Martin, the pass inside deflected by A&T. And then on a save attempt, a pushing foul is going to be called on Quinnipiac. No, I believe it. Or was that a timeout call?
No, Samantha Guasella pushed the A&T player, and she's going to go to the foul line. But certainly the rhythm we saw in the first half is now dissipated, and it has become very choppy. So the sailboat you were on that was going real good is now in 5-6, 7-foot seas. And for both teams, it hasn't been played well in the second half.
Guastella's third personal, second five in for Quinnipiac. Warner, Napolitano, Manns, Ostergaard, and Martucci. At the line is Davis. With 10:06 to go in the second half, the free throw attempt is off the front rim. Got a friendly bounce, and she'll get one more.
And I don't want anybody to be mistaken. The quality of play is still strong. It's just the whistles and the game stoppages and the fouls have stopped anything from being free and easy.
Bends the knee, second shot is good as well. So DeAndre Davis now with 4 points for A&T, and the lead is now 61-42. Bobcats by 19 as we come up to the 10-minute mark of the second half. Ostergaard faces some pressure in the backcourt, looking to get around two defenders at the half-court line. The pass to Manns on the forecourt. Cross-court for Martucci. Wide open, left wing, three-pointer is good.
You know how good of a pass Manns just made that time off a double team? In traffic as a freshman to look opposite to a wide-open Martucci. Manns, we're going to hear a lot about her during her career.
And that's Martucci's first three-pointer to make it 64-42. 9.5 to go in the second half. Bobcats with a big lead as it's King going down the lane, forces up a layup. That is good. And a foul call as well.
Good athletic play that time by King inside. Was able to step through traffic and also get herself in a position where she could elevate and jump through the double team and get fouled.
Ostergaard with the foul, her third. So King will try to finish off a three-point play. She has 10 points already in this game for the Aggies. Senior from Alexandria, Virginia, she makes a free throw. And it is 64-45. Bobcats by 19. Still some pressure in the backcourt by A&T. Manns looking to inbound. Bounces one for Warner. Warner needs help. Finds Ostergaard. She races to the half-court line and brings it across. Double team there. Tied up momentarily. Gets it to Morgan Manns. Manns one dribbles the logo. Back for Ostergaard. Quickly inside. Warner goes up. Left side layup attempt. No good. And is recovered by Nazario. A&T on the move. Nazario to the foul line. Down the lane. Splits two defenders. Her shot no good. She's knocked to the floor. And there's contact and another whistle. And one official says a shooting foul. Wait for the official announcement. Morgan Manns with her first. And now Quinnipiac with 10 team fouls for the rest of the game. Sending to the line, Nazario missing the first.
A&T has opened it up a little bit defensively. So they're going full court pressure back to a half court trap. And you know, Quinnipiac just needs to throw ahead and go ahead and finish plays down low. You're going to get a lot of opportunity to score. What you don't want to do is get careless and you got to finish plays.
Nazario second free throw. She makes that one. 64-46, 9-11 to go, second half. Pressure stolen, the pass in the backcourt. It's Carter who recovers, gets it out to Davis. Davis one dribbles, gives to Nazario, watched by Napolitano. She dribbles between the circles, coming up to the 9-minute mark of the second half. Nazario moves to her left, so we'll be watched by Napolitano. Left side pass for Bursi, on the drive to the baseline. Layup attempt is good.
Able to turn the corner that time, and no weak side help for the first time all night for Quinnipiac.
64-48, 8:47 to go, second half. Ostergaard at the foul line, spins, fakes, splits two defenders, and able to lay it in.
Yeah, she's really tough off the bounce, you know, and you get a timeout here by Trish and get her other team back in a basketball game. But A&T creeps it back a couple times so far. They've got 21-16, but as soon as they get it to 16, Quinnipiac goes ahead and makes a basket, and they stretch it to 18.
So a timeout call. We'll keep it here with 8:38 remaining in the second half. 66-48. The Bobcats lead it. And as I look at the scoreboard to tell you that, we get the replays now. A nice plus when you're describing 6mm versus 8mm, because I remember last year all those big circle pixels that were enormous. You couldn't get rid of clarity, especially when we're looking at questionable calls.
Well, you know, Bobby, last year it was 16 pixels, so there was no comparison. What you were seeing wasn't, you couldn't really tell what it was. It was like when I grew up watching black and white TV with those little rabbit ears.
But yeah, you and me both.
This is as good as it gets here, dude, and you were able to see Ostergaard step through in traffic and make the play. Fan cam is a great thing. If you're at home right now, you need to come to the games and get your kids here and check out, which is an incredible atmosphere.
Look at the ledger. A lot of balance on the Quinnipiac side of things. Jasmine Mart at 16 points in the first half. She has 18 at the moment. You've got Morgan Manns making her Quinnipiac debut with 9 points already. Guastella with 8, 6 each for Ostergaard and Cannon. So they're sharing the load, they're sharing the ball, and everybody's feel like they have a piece of the action.
That's a good point there. You know, again, you talk about Sharon. You usually get kids that get 16 in the first half, they want to get 30. But, you know, you get Martin, it's let the game come to her in the second half. McQueen played 2 points in the first half, let the game come to her. So it's a mature group, and it's certainly a team that puts themselves along with the group. They run this race together.
So it's AT&T ball in the backcourt. Carter gets the inbounds pass. She'll be met by Jasmine Martin at the logo. Starting five in for Quinnipiac still. Carter dribbling with the right hand. Moves it to the forecourt. Closely monitored by Martin. Looking to spin and get a pick. Gets around McQueen. Dribbles to the left wing. Now to cross-court feed for Davis in the left corner. On a top, Nazario. Shot clock down to 10. Nazario hounded by Cannon, backs it up to the logo, shot clock to five. Moves to her right, to the wing, to the right corner for Bercy for a long shot. That's good. She just beat the shot clock for three.
Yeah, good patience by A&T. You know, he took the shot clock down, and he was able to knock down a three right at the buzzer.
66-51. The lead is 15. The inbounds pass to Abshire inside of 8 minutes to go in the second half. Boo double team, cross court for Guastella. She moves to the forecourt. Now to Jasmine Martin, left corner jumper. That's good.
Boy, I tell you what, she's a little too unselfish for me. She hadn't missed a shot. I'd get her the ball, and good ball reverse, corner jumper. Martin's been very, very good.
That's her fifth three of the game. She has 21. It's 69-51. Bobcats continue to hold on to the advantage in the forecourt. Carter moving to her left, splits two defenders, goes down the lane, shot blocked by Guastella out of bounds. It'll be A&T ball after the timeout. 7 minutes, 31 seconds remaining in the second half. Quinnipiac still in control, leading 69-51 over North Carolina A&T. We'll be right back.
Get your coffee from the folks that know coffee inside and out. For over 60 years, we've kept America running with our dedication to serving the freshest cup of coffee. Dunkin' Donuts, America runs on Dunkin'.
You neglected to mention the sleeper sofa. I forgot all about the air hockey table. Reluctantly helping my friend move.
Get going with the one and only taste of a Dunkin' iced coffee and reluctantly help your friend move. America runs on Dunkin'. You want your coffee quick, freshly brewed, and ground from only the finest beans. Make the most of your day with the fresh ground taste of America's favorite cup of joe. At Dunkin' Donuts, you can do it. Dunkin' Donuts coffee, America runs on Dunkin'.
Back at the TD Bank Sports Center, Bob Mortali and Bill Mecca, all Quinnipiac so far tonight in the women's season opener. First round of the preseason WNIT. Bobcats lead it 69-51. And Jasmine Martin now is within 1 point of her career high. She has 21 so far this evening, 16 of those in the first half. She had 22 twice last year, once against Mount St. Mary's in the NEC tournament, the other against Sacred Heart. It's A&T ball. On the end line, Nazario looking to throw it in for Bercy, and Bercy makes the catch, guarded by Abshire, left wing. Bercy dribbling with the right hand, looking for a pick, tries to get around McQueen and does so. Moves to the foul line, right side, gets the pass out to Davis. Check that, Carter. Carter with a jumper from straight away. That's no good off the front rim. Jasmine Martin with a rebound. She's going to go one-on-one with Nazario. Down the lane, right side, goes up with a layup attempt. No good, but she drew contact, able to get the foul call against Nazario.
A defensive possession that time by Quinnipiac. They were able to go ahead and get A&T to spread out a little bit, and Jasmine Martin breaks out in transition, is able to get to the rack.
And that's five personals on Nazario. She's done for the evening, finishing with 11 points, six in the first half and five in the second half. 7:12 to go in the second half, and coming off the bench will be Debbie Smith to replace Nazario. And Jasmine Martin with an opportunity here, if she makes them both, to set a career high in scoring. 21 already, 2 of 2 from the foul line in the first half.
Well, she's been extremely efficient, and she makes her first miss, and she isn't clean anymore. So,
you know, Coach Tipson gives me a lot of grief for giving a foul shooting number and then seeing the player miss.
Well, you don't have that much control over what players do, so tell Tip to relax a little bit.
She makes the second, and she has 22 in the game. That'll tie her career high, and the Bobcats lead at 70-51. 7:08 left, second half. Carter working on Martin, dribbling to her right. The pass to McCray right of the foul line. Defended by McQueen, bounces one to Smith on the curl. Smith to her left, down the lane. Feet inside, intended for King, and is knocked away, taken off by McQueen. Outlets for Cannon. Cannon to the forecourt. Guarded closely by Bercy. The feet inside. Guastella on the low post. She banks it in.
What a feed that time by Cannon, who goes up in transition. Spots up for the three. Guastella, good streak time. Good flip pass. Good pass, good finish.
Samantha now in double digits with 10 points at 72-51. Bobcats by 21 with 6.5 to go in the second half. Carter into the left corner for Smith. On the drive, left baseline shot blocked by Guastella, who never left her feet. And Quinnipiac controls down court to Martin, who lost a handle on it. Had a 2-on-1 break, but she couldn't handle the pass. It goes out of bounds.
Well, good run that time. And Jazz wanted to go ahead and flip it with her left hand to a streak of McQueen. It just slipped out of her hand.
6:20 to go, second half. Bobcats moving closer to a quarterfinal game on Monday night in this preseason women's NIT tournament. It's A&T with a basketball. Carter moving to her left, watched by Martin. Continues to dribble with the right hand between the circles. Out by the logo. Shot clock down to 10. Carter at the left wing. Gets around Guastella. Moves to the foul line. Feet quickly inside for King. Has to control it on the end line. She banks it in.
It's a play there by A&T. Now, they got to run their stuff. It's a long season, and they just got to look to get better.
King with 13. It's 72-53. Abshire double-teamed across the way, and quickly Trish Fabry calls a timeout to avoid a tie ball situation. 5:43 left in the second half. It's Quinnipiac 72 and A&T 53, and more opportunities coming in the next few minutes, I would assume, for some of the second, maybe third-teamers to add more minutes and to work on some things to get ready for the second game on Monday.
Well, I think what you need to do, especially with that second group that's going to come in the game now, is you're going to get your rhythm and your timing with some new players. I think Mann certainly has showed that she can play at this level. I like Martucci in there. But again, it's a team that hasn't played a lot of minutes together. So the more reps they can get in game situations, the better served they will be as they move forward. So all in all, it's been a real strong performance by this Quinnipiac women's basketball team tonight.
And again, Quinnipiac, if they hold on to win, would play either Louisville or Loyola of Chicago on Monday. Loyola, by the way, coached by WNBA legend Cheryl Swoops, will be making her debut tomorrow against the Cardinals down in Louisville. Quinnipiac ball, Ostergaard looking to work on Bercy, top of the circle. Finds Martucci, left wing, dribbles once. Not a Mans, top of the three-point arc. Left side for Martucci once again, dribbles to the left corner. Back for Mans, wide open for a three-pointer. That's off the back iron, no good off the floor. Rebound, still fought for, tied up. Warner diving for it, and they'll say the tie ball whistle with the arrow in favor of A&T. So it's Aggie's ball as Bercy able to get that call for A&T. 5:20 to go, second half. Of course, those of you who follow major college basketball last year recall Louisville going to the title game last year before losing to UConn. So if it is going to be Quinnipiac and Louisville Monday, that's going to be a huge challenge for this Bobcat squad. A&T with the basketball, dribbling behind her back is Carter at the left wing, guarded closely by Martucci. Throws one to the corner for Bercy. Bercy dribbles to her right. Picked up by Martucci between the circles. 5 minutes to go, second half. Bercy on the drive. Now the right side pass in for McCray, able to bank it in.
A&T's doing a pretty good job controlling the ball up top and able to dribble penetrate and dish to the inside players.
72-55, 4:48 to go, second half. Ostergaard, left wing, dribbling with the right hand. Throws one to a wide open player in the corner. That's Mans, pulls up the trigger. That's no good. Rebound by A&T. McCray able to get it to Bercy. Bercy in the forecourt against Napolitano. Feet inside. It was like a no-look pass intended for Debbie Smith, deflected out of bounds. And the call will be in favor of Quinnipiac.
Yeah, what A&T can't do at this point now, and making a good little mini run here, is they can't have any unforced errors. And that time she just threw the ball out of bounds. And look for the Bobcats to finish this play at the foul line.
72-55, Bobcats by 17. Martucci straight away to Ostergaard on the drive. Left side, she pump fakes, draws contact, hits the bucket, and she's fouled.
And good move by Ostergaard that time. She able to get the benefit of, I think, which was a late whistle with the N1 play. So Ostergaard had been fouled. She waited. The girl cleared her back, and she was able to finish the play.
Christina Carter picks up her third personal foul. And the nice thing about that play is Ostergaard really couldn't see the defender all that much, knew she was coming, stopped her momentum, draw the contact, and make the shot.
Yeah, she's got real good vision about her, you know. And again, it's that innate thing that you're able to feel your defender as she makes the free throw. Felt and knew she was coming on her back, and certainly strong enough to finish the play.
Ostergaard makes it 75-55 on the three-point play with 4:11 to go. Second half, Carter bounces one for King. Watched by Mans, moves to her right. She's picked up now by Warner. Left side, Bercy. Needs help. Dribbles with the right hand twice. Sets it up for Davis. On the left wing, guarded by Ostergaard inside of 4 minutes to go. Shot clock down to 9. Ball poked away, recovered by Carter. Left baseline on the drive. Able to find a seam and bank it in.
Yeah, good dribble penetration in the second half by A&T.
75-57. Bobcats lead it. Ostergaard double team on the backcourt. Needs some help. Gets it to Morgan Mans. Able to get it across the midcourt line to the logo. Now the pass to Martucci. Far sideline on the drive. Running one-hander. No good. Martucci with a rebound for Mans. Three-pointer. That's no good from the right side. Control off the rebound by A&T. And Mans going to get an over-the-top reach and foul. Call against her as A&T started to move the possession forward.
Yeah, a little fatigue foul that time by Mans, and a little tired that time, and a little lazy defensively. Was able to pick up a foul, and you don't want to give A&T baskets with the clock not running.
And the stoppage of play, 3:30 to go, second half. All Bobcats down the stretch. Quinnipiac leads 75-57 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special. $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com.
Take a trip down the aisle you'll never forget at Mamma Mia, Broadway's smash hit musical based on the songs of ABBA. Everyone's having the time of their lives at this guaranteed get happy hit about a mother, her daughter, and three possible dads. How can you resist?
See Mamma Mia at the Schubert New Haven, November 22nd through 24th. For tickets, visit Schubert.com. Sponsored by Lexus and Whitney Center.
The festive atmosphere continues here at the TD Bank Sports Center. It's been all Bobcats from the opening tip in the first half, now leading at 75-57 with 3.5 minutes to go in the second half. We just received word, by the way, that the hockey game will start 30 minutes late because the bus from Brown University was late. So those of you waiting for hockey later on will have the opening faceoff for you at 7:30 on the web with the pregame show at 7. So Christina Carter's at the foul line for North Carolina A&T. Basket to our left. Free throw off the back iron. No good. One more to come.
At 21 free throw attempts by A&T and only 10 for 21 from the line. So they've left a lot of pins standing tonight.
Second free throw around the rim and goes in. So for Carter this afternoon or this evening, 8 points. And the Bobcats lead is 75-58. In the forecourt, Warner left of the foul line to Mark Napolitano. The three-pointer's no good, but Warner able to get the rebound and a quick foul call as she was pushed from behind. Might have gotten popped in the head a little bit.
I like the group in here. I do. I like their quickness. I like Martucci in there. Real good hands. Lean and long is able to complete some passes. So you're not going to have a lot of slippage when Gold Rush comes in versus the starting group. So it's a group that's 10 strong, maybe 12 strong as Warner makes the free throw.
Rattles around the rim and falls in. Tracy King will foul her fourth.
Yeah, I think I always used to think as a coach it's difficult to keep seven or eight people happy, you know, and you only settle with eight as Warner makes a free throw. But it's certainly a group that believes 10 is the magic number, and 10's been special tonight for Trish and the team.
And in many ways, when the team is successful, there's less need to worry about my points or my minutes because everybody's sharing in the wealth of the win.
No doubt.
Coming up to the 3:05 mark in the second half, it's 77-58, Bobcats by 19. McCray, right side low post, shot no good, rebound, they tie it up as she and Warner battle for the rebound. It's Quinnipiac ball on the possession. Coach Fabry wants a foul, but you're going to get the ball anyway. And now we're going to get another lineup change, five in, five out, but this time we'll have Sheena Earl with getting additional minutes in the backcourt. Katie Carroll returns to the lineup, joined by Guastella, Ellen Cannon, and Jackie Oscom. Bobcats ball in the backcourt. Inbounds pass intended for Carroll. It had it knocked away. Tried to save it on the sideline. No, unable to do so. It's A&T ball.
Yeah, full court pressure here now and get some new combination of players for Quinnipiac. So that time against their press offense, they weren't where they needed to be.
A&T will inbound on the sideline to our left. Bursey to throw in for Carter. Carter's watched by Earl. Pass on the right side for Bursey on the baseline. Kicks it back out for Davis. Three-point shot is no good. Guastella able to tip it though into the hands of Davis. Puts two defenders on the drive. She's fouled on a shot attempt. So A&T about to shoot free throws once again. Now the question is, of the two Quinnipiac players in the mix, who's the foul going to be on? It's Katie Carroll's first personal.
Now, good defensive set that time by Quinnipiac. And again, they just didn't turn around and pursue the basketball. Long shots, long rebounds.
Davis at the line. She's now 3 of 3 from the stripe this evening. And she makes the first. 5 points on the afternoon. 2:45 to go in the second half. Davis bends the knee. Second free throw. Front rim no good. Rebound off the floor. Loose. Guastella goes to fight for it. Arrow on the possession now, this time in favor of the Aggies.
Well, it hasn't been a real clean game in the second half, and I think the officials had a lot to do at the start to half with just a lot of whistles. 55 personal fouls in tonight's basketball game has slowed down the rhythm of the game.
Aggies with the ball, far sideline. It's Davis in front of the A&T bench. Goes inside, pass from McCray, knocked away by Carroll out of bounds, and A&T will try it again. With 2:36 to go in the second half, Bobcats still with a double-digit lead at 77-59. Headed for a Monday night game against either Louisville or Loyola Chicago in the WNIT quarterfinals. Inbounds pass to Carter, dribbles in front of the A&T bench. The blue pass to the foul line from McCray, double-teamed. And it's going to be a foul call against Quinnipiac. It's like Ellen Cannon this time. That's Ellen's first.
Well, they're looking to feed McCray the ball down there in a low post. And you know, Quinnipiac looking to make a play. But I think with 2:30 to go, you probably just want to go ahead and McCray catch the basketball and really work on your post defense. So any touch is a foul, and McCray goes to the line.
And misses the first of the two free throws. Now Tepetope Oladele back into the A&T lineup, replacing DeAndre Davis. And we've been mentioning depth and fresh bodies throughout much of the night. It looks to me like A&T is definitely wearing down to use an eight-player lineup. And they look a little winded with Quinnipiac still with the fresh fives every time you look down there. And the Bobcats in control, leading 77-60. Quinnipiac ball, Oscom. Try to tiptoe the end line in the basket to our right. Unsuccessful, though. It's A&T ball.
Well, this group has not played a lot of minutes together, and you can see some sloppy play right now trying to figure out, okay, what do you want to do? There's 2:20 to go. Coach wants us to hold the ball, or do we want to look to play and look to finish play? So it's always an awkward time in a game where you're up 17 or 18 points because you're just not sure, does Coach want me to push or do you want me to take time off the clock? So I'm a big fan in just playing it out, push a little bit, and the best team will always win.
Another discussion across the way with the officials as Deb Garcia goes to the scores table. Everything seems to be in order. All the clocks are in sync at the moment. And we're back to live action. Carter with a basketball for A&T, dribbling in front of the A&T bench. Splits two defenders. Tied up by Shayna Earle, who got a whistle for a tie ball possession of Quinnipiac. Nice play by Shayna.
Shayna did a good job that time. And again, the more reps Shayna gets, the better off Shayna's going to be.
2:15 to go. Quinnipiac to inbound. It's Earle in the backcourt. Brings it across. She's picked up by Carter. Spins on Carter. Dribbles to the top of the three-point arc. Left side, Guastella to Oscom. In front of the Bobcat bench. Fakes. Not a cannon. Right wing. At the two-minute mark. Bounce one of the low post for Carroll. Goes up strong. Shot no good off the backboard. Taken off by Bercy. A&T with the basketball across the logo. Bercy to the forecourt. At the right wing. Right side pass for King. King hawked by Oscom. King on the drive to the right baseline, and there's going to be a whistle. Contact. Shayna goes down. Foul call against Quinnipiac.
Yeah, reaching foul that time by Quinnipiac, and negated really good defensive play by Shayna Earle, who stepped in there and would have got the offensive foul if you didn't get the touch foul on Quinnipiac.
So it's Ellen Cannon second with a minute 44 to go. Quinnipiac also on the verge of winning its 16th consecutive home game here. They were 15-0 all last season on that memorable run to the conference title in the 30-win season. King misses the first. One more to come. King with 13 so far this evening. And she makes the second attempt. So it's Quinnipiac in front, 77-61, minute 40 to go. Earl working on Carter as they bumped at the logo. Dribbling with the left hand. Carter goes down. Oscom gets the pass and the shot around the rim for three-point range. No good. Cannon dies to the floor, gets tied up momentarily. The thumbs go in the air, the whistle and the arrow now in favor of A&T, but a nice gutsy move by Cannon to dive into the pile and try to pull it away.
Now, real good job by Ellen Cannon that time. A little unlucky for Oscom as she almost knocks down the three-pointer, but Cannon getting her body dirty down there and almost coming up with a play.
1:25 to go, 77-61. Bobcats in front. Carter watched by Earl across the way, far sideline, moving to her left. Continues to dribble with the left hand, now stops on the wing. Tied up, good defense by Earl. Can't find a passing lane, and a whistle across the way, and a timeout called by A&T with 1:13 to go in the second half. Still the 16-point lead at 77-61, so there will be a second game on Monday night, most likely for this Bobcat women's team, all a matter of where it's going to be.
Yeah, pretty good chance, as you had mentioned before. You know, Louisville's got to be the number one seed in this event, number two seed in this event. So, you know, look for Quinnipiac to head out to Louisville. And Quinnipiac's not afraid of playing teams that are up on the schedule. So it's a competitive group. It's got groups that can play at another level. And be fun to watch, fun to listen to.
And, you know, last year of the three losses, two of the teams they lost to were in the Atlantic Coast Conference. So they're getting used to playing the highest caliber opponent. And, again, remember in the Maryland game, they were looking pretty good in the first half for a while.
And in Maryland's athleticism and strength just took over, and you started missing some shots, and it snowballed a little bit.
A&T basketball inbounds pass to Carter. She's watched by Earl. She moves to her right between the circles. The blue pit for McCray at the right side of the foul line. They work it back to Carter. Pull-up jumper from the foul line. No good with four on the shot clock. Rebound 4-4. Carroll goes to the floor. It's taken off by A&T and a whistle for a foul on the putback attempt with 57 seconds left. Guastella with her fourth personal. That'll send McCray to the line. ...77-61. McCray, kind of a two-hand push on her shot, and that's no good. In fact, unofficially, we have her now just 2 of 6 from the line today. You mentioned the foul shooting problems that have caused some issues with A&T, and it continues to hurt them the longer they go in this game. Second free throw no good as well, and it's Quinnipiac ball. Shayna Earl controls with 54 seconds to go. Spin to the half-court line, finds Guastella, three-pointer straight away. Back iron no good, rebound off the floor to Tracy King. A&T ball, King into the forecourt with 43 seconds left. Bounces one to her left for Carter. Carter pats the top of her head. 37 seconds to go, it's a 16-second difference, game the shot clock. Carter switches hands on the dribble, left wing three-pointer, that's in and out. Hit the rim again, Carroll with the rebound. Shot clock is off and she'll control for the Bobcats. Gets it out to Earl. Earl, far sideline to the forecourt against Carter with 20 seconds left. To Carroll, not a cannon. Fakes the three-pointer, goes to the baseline. The pass inside, stolen by King with 13 seconds to go. King to the forecourt, working on the left wing, kicks it back for Carter. Carter fakes, now drives in the lane, feet inside for King on the baseline. The shot from the other side is good by Oladele with 3.6 to go to make it 77-63. Inbounds to Earl, she'll just run it out. And that is it. Season opener and a victory for the Bobcats as they move on to the quarterfinals of the preseason WNIT. The Bobcats easily handle North Carolina A&T. Final score, 77-63. Stay tuned for the postgame show. We'll be right back.
Here's to Guastella. Now to Lee back along the right sideline. Dribbles into the lane and out to Guastella. Top of the key for three. Good.
Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball brought to you by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. By Pepsi, the choice of a new generation. By Dunkin' Donuts, America runs on Dunkin'. By Moro Motors, Mercedes-Benz and BMW of North Haven. By Mass Mutual, they'd like to help you make good financial decisions to protect the people who matter most to you. And by the Beach House Restaurant in Milford. What's not to like? Great food, great staff, super music.
In 400 feet, turn left. Recalculating. In 300 feet, make U-turn. Recalculating. In, 200, recalculating. In 50 feet, no 40, no 30. Can you just slow down for a second? Okay, I'm pretty sure you missed that turn on purpose. Recalculating. Hello? Are you even listening to me?
With the BMW X1, there's no predetermined route. You can go anywhere and do anything. And with S-Drive, BMW's dynamic rear-wheel drive system, you can have the performance you expect from a BMW in a sport activity vehicle. Because we only make one thing.
Don't mind me.
The ultimate driving machine. GPS optional equipment.
Test drive the all-new X1 at BMW of North Haven. Proud sponsors of Quinnipiac Athletics. Love my BMW of North Haven.
Game number one in the books for the Quinnipiac women as they easily handle North Carolina A&T in the preseason WNIT, and Coach Trish Fabry has the headset on. I'll tell you what, the first 10 minutes of the game looked a lot like this team didn't miss a beat from last year.
Well, they defensively, A&T really made it a game plan to front Brittany and limit touches, and what we were able to do very effectively was skip the ball and make a lot of threes, and Jazza Martin got us off to a fantastic start for this new year, and everyone just followed suit Once someone got going really quickly, as Jazz did, led the way for us, everyone felt really good, settled into the game. So it was nice to see those balls not only go up but go in, more importantly. So I think our team did a great job recognizing where they were taking away front side of stuff and skip and shot and make shots. But that, again, starts with Jazz making shots. Everyone breathes a lot easier, and off we went. So it was a really good start for us.
And a lot of moving parts. You had a lot of balance in the scoring, a lot of balance on the rebounding side, so everybody's chipping in. And, again, that's something it's standard operating procedure with this unit.
Look, we're not going to go away from what we've been able to do. We've got a talented roster, and you saw that again tonight with a lot of parts to make a great whole. And, you know, we were unsure if we were going to be able to be as effective to start the season in the five in, five out. Last year, we did not do that.